only half Arabic, actually. My dad is Palestinian. I mean, he's a U.S. citizen. He's not a threat to national security or anything. A lot of people want to know that after they meet him because he has an angry energy. But not like angry at America, just angry at my mom for leaving him. Although she did leave because he was angry, and he was angry because she's American. My name's Abed, by the way.
Abed, nice to know you and then meet you in that order. Now, about that question that I had?
Oh, 5 after 11, when you asked.
Abed.
Yeah.
What's the deal with the hot girl from Spanish class? I can't find a road in there.
Well, I only talked to her once while she was borrowing a pencil, but her name is Britta. She's 28, birthday in October. She has 2 older brothers, and one of them works with children who have a disorder I might want to look up. Oh, and she thinks she's going to flunk tomorrow's test, so she really needs to focus, and she's sorry if that makes her seem cold.
Holy crap. Abed, I see your value now.
That's the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me. Oh, hey, text message. Let's give this bad boy a read.
It's probably just for you.
I've never gotten one of these.
It's probably you just for your
eyes. Say you have to pee, I need to talk to you. Say you have to pee.
That is weird.
Say you have to pee, yeah. I need to talk to you.
Do you have to pee?
No. It's so weird.
Well, I'm stumped.
You know, I thought you were like Bill Murray in any of his films, but you're more like Michael Douglas in any of his films.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you have Asperger's.
What's going on? Can you guys hear me? Am I deaf? Can you hear me talking right now?
Yes.
That's good.
But maybe when Jeff gets here, we could talk to him as a group about his tardiness.
Oh, come on now. Don't use that word around, Abed. In any case,
when it's all over.
Spoilers.
It's gonna be as if it never even happened. Hey, Abed, real stories, they don't have spoilers. You understand that TV and life are different, right?
Abed, do you want to trade cards?
No.
I'll give you 20 bucks.
No.
50 bucks.
No. I don't want your money. I want your shirt.
What?
This is really nice of you. The memo says 4 dreams.
You go host American Idol and you stop messing with my son. He's a special boy. I raise him, okay? You don't raise him. It was hard enough to talk to him before. Now we have this between us.
I'll have to make some adjustments to my film. Jeff, I think you should play the role of my father.
I don't want to be your father.
That's perfect. You already know your lines.
Is that a new camera?
Yeah, it's more expensive, but it lets me adjust really specific settings that most people don't notice or think about.
So, Abed, how's film class?
Good.
Yeah, did you go to class today?
Not really.
Not really. Well, Britta's paying for those classes. Don't you think maybe you should go?
I was shooting my movie.
Yeah, but your movie's for class.
My movie's more important. What do you think, Dad?
I think you are really weird, Abed. Hey.
Hey, you don't really have tickets for Ravi Shankar, do you?
I lied to get you here because it's time to communicate.
Communicate? Have you met Abed? Abed may not be a great filmmaker, but that doesn't mean that he wants to make falafel. You need to let him make his own decisions.
Make his own decisions? Have you met Abed? You know
obviously,
who he is?
Guys. Yes,
you
I know.
You have
guys.
No.
I'm finished.
I need to talk to you about Abed. He's not normal.
My son is hard to understand. If making movies help him be understood, then I pay for the class.
Abed.
Yeah.
Did you do all of that to me on purpose? But that's not a very nice way to treat your friends.
Well, Britta, it isn't called friend business. It's called show business. Am I crumping?
No.
Am I crumping?
No.
Am I crumping?
No.
Am I crumping now?
Gives you sonic hearing.
All hearing is sonic.
How about you, Abed? It's tomorrow.
Ooh, tomorrow? They're showing all 4 Indiana Joneses at the Vista. I'm really looking forward to the first 3. I bought a whip.
Is it on pause?
No. It's just him. Sorry you've been waiting 26 hours. Just gonna be another 5 minutes.
Okie dokie.
Oh my. Okay. But you told me to bring subjects.
Yeah, subjects! Not Rain Man!
Go home!
Go.
See ya.
That was the experiment, Troy. We were testing to see how long people would wait in the room.
Whoa.
Oh, gotcha.
Gotcha? That's all you have to say?
Yeah.
You sat in a room for 26 straight hours. Didn't that bother you?
Yeah, I was livid.
Then why didn't you leave?
Because you asked me to stay and you said we were friends.
Abed, here. I wanted to say sorry for yelling at you.
Indiana Jones, cool.
I just got the first three because
the fourth one blows. We're cool.
Hey, man, that stuff I said this morning wasn't true. I was just messing with you.
You were lying?
Yeah, as a joke. You never had somebody mess with you before?
Yes, just kidding. No. Like that? This isn't a table. That's funny. Hey, Troy. Did you hear? All dogs are blue now. Every single dog in the world is blue. I'm just messing with you.
Yeah, I know. But let me explain to you a few things about how this works.
Okay.
First of all, I cannot be got because I am not gullible like you. Mm-hmm. Secondly, you are not good at this because you are not believable in your face, okay? Yes. Your face?
Yeah.
It's bad.
Okay.
Also, you gotta ride the line between believable and... What are you writing in?
It's a notepad.
Yeah, but what language?
It's probably Arabic.
Beginning transmission. The primary purpose seems to be male bonding, and the attitude during conveyance of the random deceit is apparently of great importance. The humanoid is approximately 5 feet, 10 inches in height.
What are you doing?
Oh, hey, Troy. I didn't see you. How long were you standing there?
You trying to mess with me?
Yes, that's what I was doing. You got me. I was just messing with you, but I guess I blew it again.
Yeah. You did.
Greetings, Abed.
Greetings, Commander.
Tell me about the one they call Troy.
Well, he is rather arrogant and has no mercy for weaker beings.
Stop. Stop doing this right now.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm not an alien.
I never thought you were, but this is insane, okay? Those are credible alien hand movements. You invented a whole language. I'm pretty sure you rented a green screen.
Yeah.
It would be less creepy if you were actually an alien.
But this is what friends do.
No. From now on, Abed, friends don't mess with each other. Okay?
Cool.
Cool.
Cool. Bang. Is this Bruce Wayne's face? Does he know he stole it?
Yeah, I don't think so, but enjoy it.
Can we get sued?
Not sure.
Will they or won't they? Sexual tension.
Abed, it makes the group uncomfortable when you talk about us like we're characters in a show you're watching.
Well, that's sort of my gimmick. But we did lean on that pretty hard last week. I can lay low for an episode. Taking a pill?
Yes, I am.
Xenolevated. My grandpa took that when he was around your age.
Fantastic.
Really helped him with his going problem, but by the time grandpa got up in years, his memory wasn't great, he'd mixed the wrong pills. You know how old people are?
Heard stories about it, yeah.
One time he started hallucinating and ran down the street with no pants on, which in the Gaza Strip is considered a real party foul, so you should probably be careful.
Anything look, I really don't need your advice, and I'm not your pantsless grandpa.
Pantsless grandpa.
Can I live with you?
Yeah, cool. You want the top bunk or the bottom bunk?
Top.
Me too. Racing for it. Boom! Jeff, did I say anything in my sleep last night about farm animals or Brian Williams?
I don't think so.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Lucky Charms?
How are you so satisfied all the time, Abed? I mean, don't you ever want anything more out of life than cereal?
Sometimes I like to pour hot cocoa mix into cold milk and drink it like a cold hot chocolate. I call it special drink. Really great to have somebody to watch stuff with. My dad never wanted to watch anything, so I was kind of raised by TV.
TV's the best dad there is. TV never came home drunk. TV never forgot me at the zoo. TV never abused and insulted me. Unless you count Cop Rock.
Cop Rock. That sounds cool.
Doesn't it?
Britta, may I have a word?
Yeah.
What am I supposed to do about that?
Use your lady parts.
Abed!
Don't be naive, Britta. The charge between you two is keeping them going. Tell him you'll make love to him if he takes a shower and finds a nice place to live.
Hey.
You look like you moved out.
I checked into a motel and I'm looking for apartments. You would have been fine with me staying there forever, huh?
Yep.
You're pretty cool, I'll bet.
You're a huge nerd.
Thanks.
I know what you're gonna say. You watch my movies on the website. I'm a student of human character. I know you guys all so well, I can predict your behavior. Like, Shirley, I know you're a sweet, Christian, generous person. Oh,
that's nice.
I also know you have thinly veiled rage issues.
Careful, boy.
Oh.
That's my newspaper.
What do you need a paper for? You knew what was gonna happen yesterday, you Middle Eastern magic eight ball. Pierce hurt his leg. We're gonna make Troy cry.
Somewhere out there. Troy, sing. The assignment is to train a rat to respond to a specific song.
Yeah, did you have to pick a duet?
Somewhere out there, beneath the pale moonlight. He did it! Good boy, Fievel. Commencing reward. I have to open the cage.
Fievel. Jacket, let's do this.
Is there a rat in here?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, bit. El Tigre. I thought you might want to help me out because we are friends.
Abed, take it from a former prom king. Real friends help me with things, not vice versa.
I would face my fears to help you.
Exactly, because you're my friend.
Am I? Somewhere out there, what? Beneath the pale moonlight.
If he gets any nuttier, they're going to put him on The View.
Fievel? Thank you.
You think you're better than me?
No.
You stick to quote movie lines. I'll stick to sports.
Trying to reduce my pop cultural referencing.
Well, you're not moving into sports.
Troy and I play basketball. It's fun.
Don't gloat. It's impossible to guard you. Your eyes are too gentle and mysterious. Hey. I can't believe you beat me again!
Do you want my stuffed animal?
We're arm wrestling.
No! Well, like Stallone and over the top. But I'm not sure of all the rules. Don't I need a semi-truck and a 10-year-old son?
The rules are, you suck! Let's go!
I want to wait for a more inspiring song. The score isn't right. There we go. I don't like those apples. I'm so upset.
Attention, Greendale students. Don't use the condoms. If you're going to have sex tonight, don't use condoms.
Hey! Hey! You took all the winter doodles. What are you, a douchebag?
They're for my friends, but there's a lot of other cookies left.
No, there's only macadamia nut cookies here, okay? I have a tree nut allergy.
And you should probably stay away from Christmas tree-shaped cookies.
That did not even make allergic sense. What are you, an idiot?
Okay.
We get it. You and the A-team are awesome. Now beat it.
Oh, look at that. Pretty boy standing up for Birdface over here. Give me a winter doodle.
If you're trying to be menacing, maybe don't call the cookie by its name.
Oh, you're funny. You're a funny man. Wanna hear something funny, funny man? Knock, knock. My fist up your balls.
Who's there?
Decorative themes.
Why do you guys do stuff like this?
Because it's fun.
Yeah. This character reboot is really gelling for you, Jeff. That was all classic Hawkeye. Sending soldiers out for liquor, slyly sidestepping the problematic scrutiny of Annie Hot Lips Edison. Hmm? I should build you a still for making Hawkeye martinis.
Of all your pop culture fixations, this is one I can work with, Abed.
Call me Radar.
When you've earned it.
I like his idea of ironically saying, you go, girl.
You go, girl.
You go, girl.
You do what you think is right.
That's enough.
Okay. Jeff, what's your favorite episode of MASH?
The one with the army.
That's what I thought. If you'd ever actually seen the show, you'd know that Hawkeye didn't just bed nurses and drink martinis. He also had blood sprayed on his face and barked orders when the choppers came in. If he didn't, people died. He was a leader, Jeff. That's your job.
Thank you, Radar.
Oh, you made me so happy I just peed a little.
About what I'm calling our library's backdoor conundrum.
Sounds like a porno with Kate Winslet.
Abed, ew.
Why are they looking at me like I'm a zoo animal?
Well, Jeff acts as sort of the dad of the group, so emotionally this is kind of like being told that you're a new mom.
But you know it's nothing like that, right?
Absolutely. Do you cook macaroni?
I have.
Macaroni's my favorite.
Ooh. Irony?
Well, you're not a typically vulnerable or feminine person, mm-hmm. and the act of dancing is considered both vulnerable and feminine.
Mm-hmm. Dancing at discos, eating cheese on toast. Yeah, you made me merry, made me very, very happy. But you obviously, you didn't want to stick around. So I learned from you.
Everybody.
Five letters, Broadway musical.
Annie.
Six letters to puncture.
Pierce.
Okay. A water filter that starts with B.
Britta.
Okay. It's a tough one, though. Helen of...
Troy.
Oh, damn. You're good.
Thank you.
I never even heard that last one. All right. One of the two brother actors, Bridges. Four letters.
Hmm.
I know. Bridges.
I don't know.
Come on, guys. Can't you see the pattern there? Can you see it? It's Bo. Bo Bridges. These are all things you can see on TV.
Except for Pierce. That's a misdirect.
Oh. I love misdirects.
I love the Big Lebowski. Hey, guys.
Hola.
Hey, I hope you don't mind. I invited Senor Chang. We're Netflix friends.
It's the year 2006 AD, and nuclear war has ravaged the planet.
I must have missed that.
Nice.
Directed by Kim Yang. Asian. Can't direct, can't drive.
Dude, I'm right here.
Right there.
When are we doing this again?
Well, actually, tomorrow we were all gonna get together.
No, but we were all gonna get together tomorrow.
No, right?
Tomorrow night, we're all gonna get together to watch Kick Puncher 2, codename Punch Kicker.
We better change the sniper. That's change we can believe in.
Okay, obviously something strange is happening here.
What do you mean? I'm making jokes during a movie.
Yeah, but you're doing it with the speed and determination of the incomparable Robin Williams.
Yeah.
Pierce, that was deep and total BS.
Yeah, this isn't about us. This is just a deflection because you can't get a genuine laugh.
Mm-hmm. All right. Maybe we're not a family. Maybe it's more complicated because unlike a real family, there's nothing to stop any one of us from looking at any of the others as a sexual prospect.
You got something, Abed?
Another muffin basket from another actress who wants to be in my next film.
Does that work?
Yep, Meryl Streep has two Oscars because of her baking. Oh, that's sarcasm, but I forgot to inflect. This sounds way more like sarcasm. Inflection is so interesting. What happened to Britta?
Justice. Having spent the year denying her attraction to me just to be alternative, Britta called me at 3 a.m. just to ask, what's up?
A drunk dial? Was there BCI?
Booty call with a capital B.
This can't be good.
It's no biggie. We give each other crap all the time.
Well, that's the point. What crap can she give you now that you hold all the cards? You've shifted the balance, like in a sitcom when one character sees another one naked.
Is that really a sitcom staple?
No, I have no idea what I'm talking about. I'm Abed. I never watch TV. Okay, cut. Okay, Leo, I'm not feeling it. I really need to believe that you're holding an imaginary duty meter. Jeff, you know Britta's defining weakness. She cuts and runs. If you do this half-assed and fail, she may leave. Then we all lose her. That's not gonna happen. Not on my watch. That's a deal breaker. Saddle up.
You know, I am sure you're a good director, but you are a horrible drinking buddy. I mean, I can't feel things with you studying me like a beige praying mantis.
You're right.
I thought you never drank.
Scorsese drank with De Niro. It's not for me. It's for the audience. Na zdrovje.
It's 3 o'clock. What happened?
The last thing I remember is you were dancing like that girl in the movie. Kids in Detention.
Breakfast Club.
Dear God, what have you done to me? I don't remember the name of the girl in the Breakfast Club. Mary. Margaret. Molly Ringworm. You broke me.
That's the reverse of my zinger from before.
Okay, please stop shouting. All right, I feel like that person in the TV show.
Oh!
13.
This is so romantic. It's just like The Notebook, except instead of Alzheimer's, Abed has someone who likes him. Pierce, it doesn't matter what she looks like. This will be great for Abed.
It will?
Aren't you excited about talking to her?
I wasn't planning on it.
What?
Guys, come on, you heard Abed. He's not interested. Drop it.
Jeff, you need to mind your own business. And Abed, you need to get with this girl immediately, if not sooner.
Yeah?
Abed, for guys like you, this kind of opportunity only comes around once in a while.
It's important to date in college, Abed. It's a time of freedom and exploration, a time when a simple pillow fight between two innocent girls could turn into a steamy night of unbridled lust. Britta knows all about it.
Okay, cool. So you guys are gonna Can't Buy Me Love Me, right?
We're gonna what you?
You're gonna Can't Buy Me Love Me. You know, transform me from zero to hero, geek to chic.
That's her? She's pretty. Which is not a surprise at all, Abed.
Okay, Abed, we're gonna be here for moral support. Just go over there and do your thing.
Okay.
Remember, be yourself.
Got it.
Great.
Cool.
Abed.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm being myself.
Go be yourself by Jenny.
But I wouldn't go over there.
How do you know that?
A lifetime of observation, mostly. A different version of me. I think it was a vampire.
Look, I know that we're all good people, and good people believe that people should be themselves, but if Abed is himself, he's gonna die alone. And if we let him be someone else without our help,
he's gonna...
I understand. I need to change who I am to someone more likable.
No, 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 sweetie. It's not about changing. It's about learning.
Learning to change?
No, it's not.
Good grief. Clear the chickens off the runway. I'll be the bad guy. Yes? Abed, you need to be someone else. Someone who eventually gets a girlfriend. Because I can't think of anything more frightening than a half Polish, half Arab virgin in his 30s. One way or the other, that story ends with an explosion.
What are you reading?
Pride and Prejudice.
So you're familiar with two sins. How about a third?
Oh. Well, I don't think we're allowed to smoke in here.
And you picked the wrong outfit, didn't you? Don Draper from Mad Men. What'd you think?
Calvin!
What are you guys doing?
They're teaching me how to be someone else.
Oh, for God's sake, what did I tell you guys?
Oh, for God's sakes, everybody, do whatever you want. Leave each other alone.
Whoa, that's a good job. How'd you do that?
10% Dick Van Dyke, 20% Sam Malone, 40% Zach Braff in Scrubs, and 30% Hilary Swank in Boys Don't Cry.
Zach Braff?
Sorry.
Can we please talk about Abed? Thanks to us, his heart's been broken.
Well, I hate to say that I told you so. So I'll shout it through cupped hands.
I told you so!
We were only trying to help.
Oh, come on, who are we kidding? Jeff's right.
Abed was happy being Abed till we had to sully his mind with thoughts of love and romance and vaginas.
Those are the big three, that's what they call them.
Poor Abed. He was probably too sad to get out of bed this morning.
Hi.
Abed. About yesterday.
Oh, yeah. You guys must be pretty upset.
Why would we be upset?
Well, I know how important it was for you that I get a girlfriend. So when Jenny went off with White Abed, it must have really hurt.
Abed, you know we just want you to be happy, right?
Yeah, I know. Everybody wants me to be happy. Everybody wants to help me. But usually when they find out they can't, they get frustrated and stop talking to me. Or they trick me into buying them ice cream and then shove me into a clothes dryer. Which I didn't want to happen with you guys, so I want to make sure that you felt like you could help me. The truth is, lots of girls like me because, let's face it, I'm pretty adorable. Mm-hmm. And my aloofness unconsciously reminds them of their fathers, so I'm more used to them approaching me.
So we didn't damage your self-esteem or anything?
Bert, I got self-esteem falling out of my butt. That's why I was willing to change for you guys, because when you really know who you are and what you like about yourself, changing for other people isn't such a big deal. My dad's bringing my cousin Abra. She's visiting from Gaza.
Does she look like you, but in a wig and lipstick?
No, that's Halle Berry. Abra wears a full burqa in public, so she just looks like someone covered head to toe in black fabric. They're playing hide and seek.
Where?
I don't think that's how it works. But the nearest body of water is 2.5 hours away.
Leagues, Abed. We don't measure water by hours.
The hilarious guy on guy.
I'm making falafel. Not edible.
He's a ringer.
A what?
You know, a con man, a grifter, a ringer. He's an expert potter who signs up for novice classes to impress people.
But if he wants to impress people, why join a pottery class? Why not just say, hi, I'm a doctor?
I'm sorry, what is going on here?
A twist on a classic formula. Normally with buddy cops, one's a straight-laced stickler and the other's a renegade, but these two have equal claim to both roles.
And why are you here?
Short answer, my cable went out. Tell them they got 24 hours to solve the case.
They do! You have 24 hours to solve it or else! Figure it out!
That's the poster.
Maybe I want to be in charge of how I'm defined.
Well, how do you think I feel?
Stay away!
Go after him on foot.
I'm going after him on foot.
Cut him off on the other side.
I'm cutting him off on the other side! He got away!
Excuse me. I have to go to the bathroom. I'll give you the rest of these chocolate-covered raisins if you save my seat.
Well, I see how that would be frustrating, but the fact is...
Your ass is on the line.
My ass is on the line.
You just got off the phone with the mayor.
I just got off the phone with the... What, the mayor? Stop doing that!
I'm trying to help. You're not doing this right.
Well, maybe you should do it.
I'm sick and tired of making excuses for you two. You're an embarrassment to the department. You're off the case and off the force. Your badges, your windbreakers, now. Now! I ain't got all day agitating my sciatica. I'm too old for this. Now get out of my sight. Thought you were badasses, huh? Real badasses work together. All I see is a housewife and a Girl Scout.
Hey, Abed.
I said get out. And don't even think about getting near this case.
Pretty harsh.
Oh, don't worry, that's what they needed.
Hey, Abed. Why are you and I the only same?
Shh. Just watch. It's beautiful.
Speaking of love, Shirley, how's it going with the sexy dreadlock guy?
Oh, I'm sure I don't have a chance with him.
Abed and I talked to him by the vending machines. He asked about you.
He specifically asked about me?
When Annie brought you up, he specifically asked, who is that?
Abed.
Oh.
What, that's what he said.
Hey, Abed, your social skills aren't exactly streets ahead. Know what I mean?
I don't. His dreadlocks remind me of the Predator. Which is weird because you're doing the actual hunting. And you seem invisible to him.
Abed, you know what I do? Mm-hmm. Before I talk, I ask myself, what am I about to say? And how might it affect each person listening?
I'm really glad you said that, Britta. The idea that you compulsively filter yourself makes your lack of flavor kind of a flavor.
I say we knock him out of the kitchen and replace him with one of our own all in one move. Then we're the ones with the chicken.
It's like a mafia movie. As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be in a mafia movie. Cool.
You make the fingers, Abed, not the decisions.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, buddy.
I agreed to give Chang 8 fingers per lunch in exchange for a 10% bump on every Spanish test. For each of us.
Oh.
Okay. 6 fingers, Wednesdays. All right. We'll be in touch, Janelle.
Thank you, Abed.
You're welcome.
Abed, the mafia movie is over.
I'm not doing a mafia movie. In fact, I don't need to use movies or TV shows to talk to people anymore. Before, I only needed them because the day-to-day world made no sense to me.
But now everyone's speaking the same language, chicken. I understand people, and they finally understand me. These were the bad times.
Abed.
What are you doing?
Making tater tots. You're right, people got sick of chicken. But I was close. I just need a new food, a new system. I'm gonna experiment with jalapeno poppers next, and then zucchini circles.
I don't get it.
It's not that complicated, Jeff. They replaced the C in circle with a Z for zucchini.
No, I mean, why are you here? You said you were close? What were you close to? To the group? To people?
Please don't do a special episode about me.
Oh, I wouldn't dream of it.
Everyone else needs my help. That's what people don't get, is that they need to get me. I just need to be able to connect to people like you can, and then I can make everyone happy.
Maybe we should just stay here and have a plate of chicken fingers.
Cool. Can we eat them while sitting on a table, like in 16 Candles?
Pick one reference, Abed.
16 Candles. Things went back to normal. Now everyone's back to being a bunch of regular schnooks, and I'm back to being a weirdo. Back to watching from the outside. For now. But you know what they'll never make a replacement for? Friends.
In my airship, and we'll visit the man in the moon.
Hey! What the hell? Hey, what? What the hell?
Sorry, I couldn't resist. Smashing the guitar of someone singing a flowing love song was on my quintessential college experience list.
Your what?
It's a list of everything that movies have taught me comprises a successful first year at college.
Yeah, right to my face, because I can take it, unlike a certain someone else.
What about Abed? Abed's weird.
I don't know about your robot, Abed.
Lubitron's great. And once someone spills bong water on his circuitry and he comes alive, he's gonna make us the coolest guys on campus and help us get babes.
Those are real babes. Who will really laugh at us.
Hey, you're my friend, right? Friends are supposed to help each other no matter what. Ridiculous situation, descending into heavy-handed drama for the illusion of story. Check.
What? That was awesome! All right, I am back in.
Thank you.
Someone here order a pizza? Is it you guys? It has extra sausage.
No.
It's making hot.
Guys, the last guy almost got me. Alex.
No big deal. Nothing's changed.
Something's changed.
Oh, Abed. Crazy Abed.
No, something's different now.
Could be me. I'm sporting a man thong.
Maybe. So no one feels it? No one senses anything's different?
Nope.
Not at all.
No, care something.
Pass that exam or my entire four-year plan, I'll be thrown off.
That might be your car, Jeff.
What?
I was on my roof for the 4th of July, and the fireworks set off all the car alarms on the street. That one sounded like a brand new Lexus.
My Lexus isn't brand new.
I know. Yours is a 2002. That's the year I heard it.
Oh, Annie.
No! No! Everyone close their eyes. Do it. Close them. Abed, close.
Oh, don't worry about me. I can only connect with people through movies.
She's the Ark of the Covenant.
Nadir, Abed, 85.
Yeah, I gotta find a new place to live. My dad wants me to leave the nest so he feels less weird that his girlfriend is 20.
You could live in a pyramid.
Oh, wait! Abed, your dorm room's got a bunk bed, right?
Yep.
Don't kegger. It's funny. I spent so much time here, I forget that we don't live together.
Then I think, what if we live together?
Here, I'm gonna check in the other peg. Last call. Study over.
What are you doing?
Just giving things a finale vibe. Hey, Jeff, do you have any hillbilly cousins?
I wish. Why?
What about a wealthy uncle? Or an old drinking buddy that may or may not have had a sex change?
Abed, why are you mining my life for classic sitcom scenarios?
I guess I'm just excited about the new year, looking for ways to improve things. I'm hoping we can move away from the soapy relationshipy stuff and into bigger, fast-paced, self-contained escapades.
Doesn't it make you want to cry?
Something like that.
I wanted to come out of the gate having adventures, like paintball. This is boring.
Well, I think that's selfish, Abed. If you were a friend to Jeff and Britta, you would see their relationship as an adventure.
I hadn't thought about it that way.
Britta's Marion! Britta's Marion! Britta's Marion Jeffrey Winker!
What the?
Where are you going?
By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you canceled.
Oh, good. Yeah, Abed, cancel us. And while you're at it, why don't you take your cutesy I can't tell life from TV gimmick with you? You know, it's very season one.
I can tell life from TV, Jeff. TV makes sense. It has structure, logic, rules, and likable leading men. In life, we have this. We have you.
And then we start competing with each other, and exploiting each other, and humiliating each other, and controlling each other. And we lose each other. We used to work together.
Cool. So he's from your origins.
This is all I need.
Excuse me, sir. You're all my friend needs. Your mouth isn't curved upwards. Did I misread something? I brought stuff people use for capers. Suction cup. Credit card. Chloroform. The credit card doesn't work, the chloroform does.
I am the smartest one in this whole group, and all I've been used for is bait and distraction. Oh, go on your stupid mission. I hope it sucks.
What did she say?
I don't know.
All I heard was suck.
I usually have one foot out of reality, and even I'm freaking out right now. He hasn't cried yet, and from what I've been told, that's not normal.
Who's normal, Abed?
It's more beautiful than I ever imagined.
You never been in it?
My dad never let me. He always had a grudge against fast food restaurants. They almost wiped out his falafel stand. But I memorized every detail of this old girl on the internet.
13 years, right, everybody?
Darkness, my old friend.
So handicapped. It isn't sealed shut. The window isn't sealed shut. It slides open when you complete the simulation.
Well, can you talk them through it? Okay. Abed, if they can open that window, they can tell us where they are and we can find them.
I was supposed to be on that thing. I know how she works.
Hey, that's why they need you to bring her home. I'll get us some coffee.
Psycho.
And these are city impound lots, any of which might be their destination.
What are these other circles?
What other circles?
Looks like you've circled public restrooms and truck stops. Yeah, there's another one.
Greendale, come in, Greendale.
Go ahead, Kentucky.
You can call off the rescue. We're coming to save you.
Abed, want to take a seat in the captain's chair? I think you've earned it.
No, thanks. I can't imagine anything that could have been cooler than what I've done today. Okay, that was cooler.
Abed, I'm pointing my thumbs at God.
I'm using one thumb to say that's great. Shirley, I read the New Testament.
The whole thing?
You know, being raised by TV and movies, I always thought that Jesus just walked on water and told people not to have abortions, but it's so much cooler than that.
He was like E.T., Edward Scissorhands, and Marty McFly combined. See, in the filmmaker's film, Jesus is a filmmaker trying to find God with his camera. But then the filmmaker realizes that he's actually Jesus and he's being filmed by God's camera. And it goes like that forever in both directions, like a mirror in a mirror, because all of the filmmakers are Jesus and all of their cameras are God. And the movie's called Abed. All caps. This is the movie. Abed. Dear God, my movie is the worst piece of crap I've ever seen in my entire life. Everyone thinks what you did was destined to happen. That it was proof that God was making my movie. A movie so good it could never exist. They think I'm a genius and they think you're a villain. You heard me praying.
I don't know what you mean.
Hey.
Hey. Where's your costume?
Trying something new.
But our costumes go together. And if you're not in yours, I'm just a guy in a spandex suit and a bike helmet. Guys, I hate to be the we've got company guy, but...
I hate you.
Shouldn't we be barricading the room?
I don't know. These guys don't seem so... I will help you.
Up and down, pull bodies.
Hey, guys. I raced here so I can save us 4 seats.
Thanks, Abed, but... Annie can't see the board from this far back. She lost her glasses.
I've never seen you wear glasses.
Yeah, I usually wear contacts, but I couldn't find them without my glasses, which I wear.
Cool.
Why name your daughter Megan? Are you stocking up for a bitch shortage?
Which one's Megan? The one with the hole in her sweater's armpit? Or the one whose tight sleeves are pushing her fat toward her elbows?
No, those are her cronies.
So Megan's the one with the crooked ears and no ankles?
Ha! Damn.
Sorry, I overdescribed again.
Oh, no, Abed. Describe those girls all you want. Yeah, Abed. Girl in the pink. Go.
Her forehead hangs over her head like a canopy. Oh. She missed a belt loop, and her stomach spills over her shorts.
Target destroyed.
That brutality.
It's called a muffin top, Abed.
Like a muffin. Clever. But you guys said it's rude to focus on imperfections. This is the stuff I'm supposed to filter, right?
Absolutely, Abed. It's just kind of a guilty pleasure to hear it about certain girls.
Like Megan and her friends, because they're bitches.
That's nice.
Who needs a soda?
I'll get it. I'm making you guys so happy, I want to keep it going.
Aww. Okay, I love Abed so much.
Hey, I know, it's like he's one of the girls.
Guys?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, do you mind not looking at me?
I don't know. Do you mind that your face makeup doesn't match your neck? When I squint, you look like a circus clown.
Okay, I beg your pardon, geek. I don't even know your peanut-headed ass.
You're right, we've never met. Like your hair and dandruff shampoo.
Filet and Megan service for one!
Okay, Abed, let's get back to the table. Yeah, Abed, go with your skank. Or keep going, up to you.
Keep going about what? Her uneven bra padding? You look like you're smuggling a lime and a coconut.
Go away, loser.
Good one. Tell that to the stitching your ready panties, or wear higher jeans on laundry day.
Damn, that just made me snuff, yo!
I might have something to say about those jeans she's wearing. But you guys, her shirt's not bad.
Bad isn't that bad when you're doing it to bad girls.
Yeah, and you're really good at it. You're like a machine.
Like RoboCop.
Exactly like RoboCop. Charisse is a bad rowboat. Sinker.
Affirmative. Why were you mean to them? Did they insult you?
No, but that top insulted our retinas. Go, girl.
Bad isn't that bad when you're doing it to bad girls.
Annie, when you laugh like that, you snort like a piglet.
Careful, Abed.
Be careful with your skin. Your face is so puffy right now, your eyes look like sewn on buttons.
You need to check that attitude at the door, Abed.
You need to check the door before you go through it, Shirley.
What? What?
Abed, you cannot talk to us that way.
Someone asked to. You guys are being bitches.
We're not bitches. We were just joking. If that makes us bitches, we're all bitches. Good point, Annie.
So new.
Affirmative. You're all bitches. Nice shirt. It would look better on a girl. Pick a bronzer. You're not fooling this with that bandit. We know this is it. You're all bitches. Triple bitches. Bitch. Hey, bitch. Bitch. You're a bitch. I'm a bitch. You're a bitch. Oh, black jeans. Nice try, Michael Penn. Those bangs aren't covering anything, five head. Peg jeans. Sweater balls.
crow's feet. What's it called when your back hair grows into your neck hair, grows into your regular hair? Look it up, because you have it. Hmm. Nice. Who taught you how to be a juice box?
Hey! Horsenap! So, what's with the clothes? I mean, you look like a toddler who got dressed in the dark.
Oh, snap! Here it comes, y'all!
Look at your face. It's like your mom was a lizard who got raped by a Muppet.
Oh. So that burn was brought to you by the letter S, isn't it?
What? Too hurt to respond? That's right. You don't have feelings. See, the rest of us feel ashamed of ourselves, so we act like bitches to make ourselves feel better. But you did it to fit in, and no matter how hard you try, you never will.
Snap, 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 snap. Give it up. Ooh, ooh, snap,
snap, snap, snap. Greendale's resident animal expert, Starburns.
My name's Alex.
Starburns joins us with his pet turtle, Shelly. Now, I understand Shelly can eat over five...
Okay. Are we going to the puppy parade or not? Because this is starting to feel like a bottle episode.
Again with the TV crap. Hey, Meatball, did you take Annie's pen to make life more like Benny Hill or whatever you do?
Abed?
I wouldn't do that. I hate bottle episodes. They're wall-to-wall facial expression and emotional nuance. I might as well sit in the corner with a bucket on my head.
Monster.
Me next, right?
Hold on! Can we please consider the threshold that we are crossing? We don't trust Abed.
He shredded my backpack.
He freed my pet monkey.
Because we corrupted him. He's our innocent.
He put gum in your hair.
Empty the bag.
Wait, Abed? Why is my name in here?
That's mine.
And Shirley's and Annie's. What is it? Charts? Some kind of calendar?
That's my personal private business.
Annie, 4 on, 28 off. Next, November 10th. Britta, 5 on, 27 off. Oh my God, are you charting our menstrual cycles?
What? Gross!
Abed, this is so personal and so accurate.
Abed, this is really creepy. I don't understand why you would do this.
I can explain. Oh, I thought you'd keep yelling over me. Okay, I can explain. You know, I have trouble reading people, and I say the wrong things sometimes, and I noticed it was happening more often with you three than it was with the others. And then I noticed fluctuating patterns, and I started graphing them. And by the time I realized what I was actually measuring, it had started to yield really positive results for everybody, so I kept doing it.
Were you ever going to tell us about this? I feel so violated.
Thanks. More chocolate?
Oh, get away from me!
Ava just became my hero.
Okay, if I could just take this time to share a few words of sarcasm with whoever it is that took this pen. I want to say thank you for doing this to me. For a while, I thought I'd have to suffer through a puppy parade, but I much prefer being entombed alive in a mausoleum of feelings I can neither understand nor reciprocate. So, whoever you are, can I get you anything? Ice cream, best friend medal, anything? Mm-mm. Okay. Sarcasm over. You're last up, Shirley. Dump your comedically huge bag and end this.
I'm not really sure what lessons we've managed to teach each other, but I'm proud of Annie.
She took to deception like Abed took to Cougar Town.
You're entering the next chapter of your life. Sadly, it's the final chapter, but it's also the longest, and if you play it right, the best. You and I, we're just two guys now. Peers. Equals.
So awesome. Maybe later you'll let me drive your car.
Oh, careful. You score any higher on this thing, the Rylands are going to recruit you to fight against the Kodan Empire.
The Last Starfighter. Did you get the 25th anniversary Blu-ray?
Was Scorpius half Scaran, half Peacekeeper? Frell, yes, I got Starfighter on Blu-ray.
You're a fan of the sci-fi original series Farscape.
Can I buy you a drink?
I always thought it's possible that the wormhole Crichton fell through moved him across not only space, but also time. Which would suggest that the Sabatians are our future selves, and Crichton is longing for a planet that no longer exists.
Huh. Hey, you're really nursing that beer.
Which would make sense, because what kind of wormhole would it be if you could only move from one place to another within the same galaxy on the same day?
You know, speaking of wormholes, what do you say we use one to teleport this conversation someplace a little more private?
That doesn't make any sense. Wormholes and teleportation are two different things. That's what I've been talking about this whole time.
I noticed.
Cheers. The first season, when you watch it the second time, is better than the third season. And the fourth season, when you watch it the fifth time,
okay,
is equal to...
Okay, What's your name?
Abed.
Abed, I'm Robert.
Hey, Robert.
Abed, would you like to have gay sex with me?
No, thank you.
Wow. Okay, so what is wrong with you that you can sit here this whole time and never pick up on the fact that a man is hitting on you?
Oh, I actually did pick up on it after a while.
You actually... And?
I really, really like talking about Farscape. It's a really good show.
Troy. I think I owe you a birthday.
I'm cool. I actually always wanted to drive this thing.
What? Oh, this is my car? Don't crash it.
I'm not gonna crash it.
Crash it, Troy.
Go to sleep, Britta. Go to sleep.
Crash his car, Troy.
Seems like a really dark chapter in our group story.
Go to sleep, Robin.
Cool.
Nobody did anything that bad, right?
What are we doing?
Yeah, what are we doing?
This is a bad idea, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I flew off the handle earlier. I apologize.
They were making out.
Abed!
Why would you say that?
Why would you do it in front of me? I'm not a coat rack. And this is the most important Christmas in the history of the universe. I'm assuming that's why we're all stop motion animated.
I vote we let it go.
What did you say we were, Abed?
We're stop motion animated.
I don't understand what he's saying.
I never understand what any of you are saying.
You guys don't see it? I noticed it this morning. That's how I knew it was a special Christmas. We've clearly entered a whole new medium.
Abed, does the word clearly mean the same thing to you as it does to normal people?
Now, how many fingers am I holding up? And, more importantly, are they still made of clay?
Three. And I told you, we're not clay. We're silicone dolls with foam bodies over ball and socket armatures.
Fascinating. And publishable. And you say you have no memory of this morning. You don't recall the emotional crisis that caused you to take shelter in this delusion.
It's not a delusion.
Very, very publishable. Abed, I've been a professor of psychology here at Greendale for many years, and I think I see a solution to this that might also help you with your situation. I'd like to do extensive sessions with you, including hypnosis.
I don't need therapy.
Nobody said you did. I just think it would benefit you and... incidentally, me, to get to the real meaning of all this.
You're right. That's it. I need to find the meaning of Christmas.
Ah, well...
If I can find the meaning of Christmas, everything will go back to normal.
Asterisk.
Abed, the dean says if you don't get help, they might kick you out of school.
Why would I want to be in a school that hates Christmas?
Man, it is cave-like in here.
What do you mean cave-like? It's a cave.
Nothing to be afraid of. The Cave of Frozen Memories is a safe place. Where we can observe suppressed experiences without being affected by them.
Can you show me how to do it?
Sure.
I'm not ejecting you for your not liking Christmas music, Britta. I'm ejecting you for lying to trick me into therapy.
Abed, they will kick you out of school. I was trying to save you.
Britta, but programmed badly. Wires with fraying ends. Functioning mad and sadly, no faith in herself or friends.
Bye, Britta.
But my dad's Episcopalian, and before the divorce, the holidays were a minefield of overlapping rituals.
I like the rituals. My parents are divorced too. My mom's Polish. She loves Christmas. Every year, she visits on the same day, December 9th. And every year, we sit and watch Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, together. Every year.
But Abed, today is December 9th. It's the last day of classes.
Yeah, that can't be right. She comes every year. Today must be December 8th. She comes every year. It's the first season of Lost on DVD.
That's the meaning of Christmas?
No, it's a metaphor. It represents lack of payoff.
Abed, I can't make it this year. I have a new family now. You'll meet them one day. You're a man now. Take care of Dad,
What's your duper?
Mommy's moved on. New family, new life. There's nothing left to do now but heal and share the experience with as many reputable journals as possible.
Great. Look what you did to the kid.
I get it. The meaning of Christmas is the idea that Christmas has meaning, and it can mean whatever we want. For me, it used to mean being with my mom. Now it means being with you guys. Thanks, Lost.
Oh!
You know what, though? What is this? What's going on?
It's a mixer.
Why is everyone from anthro class here? Are you guys picking a new study group member? And you didn't invite me?
We didn't know how to reach you.
What are you talking about? I'm everywhere.
We didn't know how to reach you.
That's not true. That's a lie.
It's a mixer. We didn't know how to reach you. It's a mixer. 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 Works every time.
I mean, I thought the show was about drug awareness. Who's going to be aware of a character that has no line?
What did you say?
There's not much to the cat costume, but can't wait to show you what's underneath.
How could you think that was a good idea?
Abed, we screwed up. You know that text we sent? It was to Britta's nephew. He sent her an emotopenis. What are we gonna do?
Fine, screw you, Abed. I can fix this. Marcus, I made a mistake. I texted the wrong person last night. You called me by name. It wasn't a mistake. Don't be afraid. Screw you, Abed. I was drunk. We can't do this. I'm drunk, too. On lust. Here's a picture. Oh, that's disappointing. Wow, who does that? That's...
Bees, you're up!
Getting rid of drugs is a great idea!
Abed, the undiagnosable.
Julian Assange is a...
You've been shot by an arrow.
Ow!
Yeah, it hurts. You have... successfully rubbed your balls on the sword.
I find a waiter and introduce myself.
Arky, barky, arg, bark, bark.
Why is he a pirate?
He's a gnome. He only speaks gnome.
Anybody here speak gnome? I don't know. Promise to fill it up before we bring it back.
She flirts with you.
I flirt back.
How?
I say something sexy.
Like what?
Abed. Why does being a librarian make her even hotter?
Keepers of knowledge. She holds the answers to all of our questions, like, will you marry me, and why are there still libraries? Mm-hmm. Hey, maybe if we're too loud, she'll shush us. Okay. Books!
Pretend like you're asleep.
Mariah, my name is Abed Nadir. My associate, Troy Barnes.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Are you the guys that keep staring at me and intermittently yelling out books?
The very same. We are both interested in taking you to the Valentine's dance, but... we are also best friends with each other.
It is of utmost importance we protect that friendship from the stresses of courting you, so we're trying to be as direct and above board about this as possible.
Will you go to the dance with one of us? And if so, which one?
We need to get something straight first. This is the cutest thing that's ever happened to me. But I don't know either one of you.
Give us a moment. New proposal. Get to know us at the dance and decide there which of us you'd like to see again.
Okay. Deal.
Nice.
What's in the briefcase?
Oh, tacos. You want one?
No.
Great. We really wanted them.
Yeah, we're gonna eat them. So, Mariah, what you get with me is the complete package. HBO, Showtime, Stars, Stars Black.
Sounds expensive.
With all due respect to my friend here, if you go with me, you can expect this on the dance floor.
Go. That is my analysis of the Saw movie franchise. That about does it, so I think it's time for you to choose.
So, curious about one thing. What was wrong with Abed?
Well, I mean, he did talk about the Saw movies for 2 hours.
Yeah, but there are 8 of them, and they're 2 hours apiece. And the first one did redefine the genre,
Troy.
And...
I would love to be his friend.
I know you would. It's incredible.
But romantically, he's... you know.
Hater, I hate her.
What happened?
She called you weird.
I am weird.
Not as weird as her. Who the hell is Nicholas Nickleby?
Well, we know there's no point, Jeff. We kind of just felt like feeling it.
Yeah, Jeff, what are you, Abed?
Oh, sorry, Abed.
No problem. Doesn't bother me. The vice president is coming. That explains the people I've noticed covertly surveilling the campus this week. Must be Secret Service.
Oh, Abed, will your reality ever come out on Blu-ray so we can enjoy it?
We've been made.
Abed Nadir, I'm Special Agent Robin Bowlers, Special Agent Keeneland of the United States Secret Service. Will you submit to a search of your person and belongings?
Sure.
If I may ask, how did you notice the campus was being observed?
I guess I noticed because I'm used to being the only observer.
Well, we're not used to being noticed.
That sounds a little sad.
He's clean. Although I could issue a warning for this bootleg of The Last Airbender.
Where were you a week ago? Keep it.
Who's there?
Special Agent Bowlers, United States Secret Service.
Do you just constantly have your own little side adventures?
Yep.
Me too.
Mind if I ask you a few questions, Mr. Nadir?
Okay.
Was there a specific reason you had to repeat the first grade?
Well, from what I'm told, I didn't know how to use scissors, I sat in the middle of the seesaw, and I always found the distinction between duck and goose to be very arbitrary.
Couldn't you just pick the sixth kid every time? That's what I would have done.
I went with four.
Jeez, get a room, you two.
What are you looking for, Robin?
Fertilizer, car battery, PVC piping, anything suspicious?
Because you think I'm suspicious? Or because you wish I was suspicious, so that you'd have an excuse to see more of me.
This was a random spot check.
Do you like me?
That's not really relevant. That's close enough.
Are you sure?
You smell like nice soap. I have to go. I'm sorry you weren't a more obvious potential threat to the country.
As the confetti gets swept away and we begin gearing up for next year's election, for GCTV, I'm Abed Nadir, saying, did you know you can make napalm out of common dish soap and cat food?
What? Why would you say that?
This was fun. Maybe you can observe me having dinner next time you're in town. Hung twice for yes, once for no. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. This is from me and Troy. When your child is a lone scavenger of the nuclear wasteland, clean water will be worth its weight in gold.
Aww.
Yes, I'm cooking podvarak.
Oh, I never had that.
I could make for you.
Oh. Okay, I'll give you my number.
Oh.
You are her boyfriend?
Yeah.
Name one guy I did that with.
Carl, Todd, Todd,
one
Kyle,
dude,
Carl,
Kyle, Jeff.
Britta.
Hi, Luca.
No! Unbelievable.
Guys, calm down. Just here for my Trekkies Do It in the Final Frontier hat.
That's my hat.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Yes, Luca. Maybe we do. Maybe we do.
Would you please leave?
How about from now on, we promise to go easier on you if you promise not to tell us any details about the guys you're dating unless they've committed genocide?
Or if they're left-handed, I want to know about that. I'm making a chart. This is fun.
I had met Abed at community college almost 2 years earlier. His obsession with pop culture had always alienated him. He'd quote movies, pretend his life was a TV show, he watched Cougar Town. It was as if he didn't want people to like him.
Courtney had nailed it. My lips started trembling. My hands and my feet went numb, my knees buckled. And as I fell to the floor, I pooped my pants.
Wrong. That's me. I did that last week.
What? Why would you pay a woman on the phone to think you're fat? Why is Pierce dressed as the gimp from Pulp Fiction?
Oh.
The wallet. Look, shakes. Did you set up a surprise Pulp Fiction birthday party?
I bet.
Mm-hmm.
What's my dinner with Andre?
It's just a movie about,
Two guys talking at a restaurant.
So this wasn't a real conversation. You were doing another movie?
A movie about a real conversation.
Did you poop your pants on the set of Cougar Town?
That shouldn't matter.
This is why we don't hang out!
Annie told me about the briefcase. Thank you.
What a waste.
Not really. Did you buy it from Willie's 100% authentic cinema treasures on eBay?
Yep.
Yeah, Willie exaggerates. I got Indiana Jones's real whip from him. He moves about 70 of those a year.
Oh, good. I thought I flushed a bunch of money down the toilet, but it's great to know that the real Pulp Fiction briefcase is safe somewhere.
You're mad at me.
I spent a week planning a party just to make you happy. And then I bailed on the party and ruined it, again, just to make you happy. Then it turns out while I was wasting my time trying to make you happy, you were making yourself happy all over everyone else by doing yet another stupid movie spoof.
I prefer the term homage. It wasn't about making me happy. I chose my dinner with Andre because it's about a guy who has an unexpectedly enjoyable evening with a weird friend he's been avoiding lately.
You think I've been avoiding you?
You and I hung out more last year. It makes sense. Everyone else is growing and changing all the time, and that's not really my jam. I'm more of a fast-blinking, stoic, removed, uncomfortably self-aware type. Like Data. Or Johnny Five. Or Mork. Or Hal. Or Kit. Or K-9. Or Woodstock and or Snoopy. Of course, Spock probably goes without saying.
I don't need you to grow or change. And take it from someone who just had a meaningless one. Sometimes emotional breakthroughs are overrated. And seriously, I need you to keep a tight, heavy lid on the little Indian girl story.
Sure.
As parties go, it was quiet, dark, and a little lame.
Nice. Abed, please. Allow me.
Okay, thanks. Let me see. Not good.
They said market price.
Welcome to a critical analysis of who's the boss. I am Professor Peter Sheffield, and I'd like to begin with a simple question. Who was the boss? Yes.
Angela.
Oh, well, class dismissed.
You really have to finish that whole book by tomorrow?
Yeah, but it's a page-turner. I'm in the chapter right now where he traces Tony Maselli's genealogy all the way back to Caesar.
Yes? Oh. Mr. Abed, what can I do for you?
I finished your book, Professor. And I've been watching episodes of Who's the Boss, and I think there's something that you might have overlooked.
Mr. Abed, will you look at my wall?
Mm-hmm.
What do you see?
Photographs.
Of what?
You.
With whom?
Tony Danza, Judith Light, Alyssa Milano, Who's the Boss Season 3 caterer, Gordon Giddyup Galligan.
I have studied this show, Mr. Abed. I am not a fan. I am not a groupie. I am an academic. When I ask the question, who's the boss, it is a rhetorical question. When I ask the question beyond the question, what is a boss,
I really think
that
it's
is
Angela,
even more rhetorical. You
boss,
are going off the wrong end with Angela.
Listen enough!
I would like you to leave my room.
My mind is open, Professor. It's as open as the door to Mona's bedroom. It's a shame yours isn't.
I beg your pardon. You know, I just got a wonderful idea. Why don't you teach the next class? That way you could share your open mind with everybody.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Pew. And so, by all known definitions of the word boss, i.e. one with authority over another, in 9 of 11 known possible fields in which one might teach, employ, guide, oversee, and or otherwise hold dominion, the empirically provable answer to the question, who's the boss, is...
Angela Bauer. Class dismissed.
Abed. You're a computer. Scan your mainframe for some juicy memories.
Jeff and Britta are having secret sex. Exhibit A, the one thing I do remember from Halloween.
Hi.
Hi.
You need some help in there?
Yeah, well, I can't use my hands in this costume, so...
Exhibit B. Something I overheard during Christmas. Why would I want to be in a school that hates Christmas?
He's got a point.
Kidding.
What are you doing later? How about some holiday benefits?
Hey! Ixnay in front of Unken Day.
Hmm. And finally, Exhibit C. The curious circumstances following the exciting conclusion of our St. Patrick's Day adventure.
Really?
Yeah. Oh!
Abed! A leprechaun took our clothes.
And you can never tell anyone, okay?
Okay, so we hooked up a few times, but there's a much larger issue here. We are friends with a grown man that clearly believes in leprechauns.
It's a special cape. Cape for justice.
What are you doing?
There's rioting in Tunisia.
The cape is premiering.
Humanity is premiering, you jags.
Show's gonna last 3 weeks!
6 seasons and a movie!
Something always brings me back to you. It never takes, no matter what I say or do.
I don't mean racist!
Hey, when I mean racist, she'll know.
Abed, stop being meta. Why do you always have to take whatever happens to us and shove it up its own ass?
Pierce tainted our special handshake with his blood money, and now we can't get the magic back.
Holy crap, you two, for real?
Yeah.
Nobody cares about your stupid handshake. A baby is coming out of Shirley's vagina 2 feet from us.
Don't worry, her contractions are still 6 minutes apart, so unless her cervix is dilated more than 8 centimeters, we still have time to get her to a hospital. I delivered a baby earlier this year in the back of an SUV.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Where was I with that at?
I don't know, off in the background.
Lake will be gone to
Abed, what do we do?
Shirley, pretend I'm saying this in a soothing, reassuring, non-robotic voice. We're not gonna make it to the hospital.
And not true. Sort of.
Annie, let it go. Hey, okay, due to an unforeseen conflict of genitals, I've been disqualified from delivering Shirley's baby, so I'm gonna have to walk you through it.
Did that just happen?
It's back.
It never left.
Abed, tell him.
Whatever, pal. I ain't in it for your revolution. I'm in it for me.
Abed, this was your idea.
I know, but I'm calling dibs on the Han Solo role before Jeff slouches into it by default.
Here, help me with this.
Sure thing, Your Worship.
Abed, stop trying to be Han Solo. It's making me embarrassed for you.
So listen up or you'll be floating home.
Thank you, Abed. Sorry, Han. Okay.
And then one of the stormtroopers shot the others, and it was Pierce. And we won. We saved Greendale.
Sounds like you guys had a lot of fun.
Yep. Honestly, I don't know how we're gonna top it next year.
Oh, I got a pitch. Why use guns? Take a hose and spray the whole school with paint. Every inch of it.
Actually, we kind of did that. Haven't you been to the library?
I'm working my way there. Oh, you can just put that anywhere.
Doing anything fun for the summer?
No plans.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool. It's slippery.
Excluding Pierce is what drove him crazy last year.
Wrong. Being crazy drove him excluded.
What's wrong?
Cougar Town's been moved to mid-season. That's never a good sign. Not cool, not cool, not cool, not cool.
Hey, buddy. Hey, it's coming back in January. 6 seasons in a movie.
6 seasons in a movie.
I found something that will help Abed. Abed, did you know that Cougar Town is an American adaptation of a 1990s British sitcom?
Cougarton Abbey.
Just been round, Cougarton Chapel.
I may be having an awakening.
Come off it, Deirdre. You've only been having a butcher's at the choir, boys.
Better than nothing. Thanks, Britta.
Can you believe that?
Hope you don't mind, Jeff, but I've got a new favorite show and I'm only on episode 6.
You guys...
Blimey. The barristers foreclosed the Abbey.
Fancy a drink, then.
Oi, fetch us a... hemlock.
Yeah!
Really? Why did everyone on Cougarton Abbey just die?
They only ran 6 episodes. That's the great thing about British TV. They give you closure.
Oh.
Hey, no. We'll find you a new favorite show. We'll find you a new favorite show. You are human tennis elbow. You are a pizza burn on the roof of the world's mouth. You are the opposite of Batman.
Abed, all your friends are here. They want to talk to you.
I don't get it. How is this different from the way he always is?
Abed, maybe this can be your new favorite show. It's a British sci-fi series that's been on the air since 1962.
Britta, you've done enough, okay? Why don't you go start a Ruiners Club? Oh, wait. Probably just ruin it.
Well, then I'd be doing a good job because it's a ruiner's club.
You ruined my analogy.
Guys, look.
Blimey, Inspector. Where have we wound up this time?
The question isn't where, Constable, but when.
Inspector, look out. Blog-ons.
Eradicate.
This is the best show I've ever seen in my entire
oh
life.
Oh my God! He just needs some space. There. Now the table is good as new. And so is Abed.
Britta, I'm sorry I was overprotective of Abed. I'll try and be more supportive of you.
Well, here's your first chance. Helping Abed has inspired me to finally declare a major. I'm gonna study psychology. African-American friends, but the larger point is, maybe I'm not done raging against the machine!
Any questions?
Does 2 UNs mean there are 2 Earths?
Yeah, sure, 2 Earths.
Parallel Earths in different galaxies or identical Earths in parallel dimensions?
The latter one.
Well, what does that say about free will?
Abed, Professor.
Right, yeah, let's begin.
Switzerland proposes a peace summit.
Good idea, Switzerland.
And maybe at the peace summit we could discuss the possibility of opening a portal to Earth 2.
Can we put a pin in that, Switzerland?
Earth 2 is out there, can't ignore it forever.
Ooh.
Switzerland is very concerned about Earth 2.
Uruguay agrees.
Kindly request.
I don't smell anything. Well, I just got it.
Wait, why are you still here?
Abed may have figured out a way we can steal weed.
Really? How?
It's simple, really. First we...
Abed, what did I tell you? You can't just mumble nonsense. No one's cutting away.
Okay, fine. Here's my actual plan.
Aim down the road.
I may have a developmental disorder.
I have a developmental disorder. Star Wars, cool, cool, cool. Mm-hmm. You understand.
Oh!
The hair color concept intrigues me because it's how I distinguish you anyway.
Abed,
mm-hmm.
You're a computer.
Yep.
You figure out a way to put us in our optimal pairings.
Maybe we should just revert to our original pairings.
But I thought you didn't want to carry Jeff. Oh, well, you just don't want to work with Shirley.
Maybe I need to take one. A test, not a penis.
Troy and Abbott's new apartment!
Hi!
Come on in.
Let me give you ladies the grand tour. Bathroom, kitchen, who cares? And this is my scale model of the rolling boulder scene from Raiders. With actual rolling boulder.
Ooh.
Yeah. Adios, Peter.
Oh.
Pretty cool, huh? Tonight, we offer something far more than boobs and billiards.
What?
One word, 2 syllables.
Don't say charades.
Yahtzee!
Starting on my left with 1, your number comes up, you go.
Just so you know, Jeff, you are now creating 6 different timelines.
Of course I am, Abed.
Smells weird.
I beg your pardon?
Smells weird. What did you do?
Abed, you don't ask someone a question like that. It's not dignified.
I wonder what happened in those other timelines.
Abed. There are no other timelines.
Excuse me for being the only married woman in a group full of horny toads who sit around all night just making googly eyes at each other.
Googly eyes?
Norwegian Troll!
What's going on in here?
Pierce is terrorizing Troy because he's jealous we moved in together.
You're the one who's jealous.
Why would I be jealous?
Because you're lonely and crazy.
Abed, help me stop the bleeding!
Everybody give me money.
Well, that ascot really softens your personality.
Pizza time! Oh. I wonder what happened in all those other timelines.
You don't have to point on the red!
And the woman was screaming and screaming and the man got killed. Abed.
Yep.
How did that story make you feel?
Embarrassed.
That's an odd reaction.
Yeah,
that makes sense. I'm turned on by how logical you are.
I'm comforted by your shiny hair and facial symmetry.
I hope you're as fertile as I am tonight.
More.
Hey, Bed. Why are you doing the whole song?
They wouldn't turn the radio on at the exact moment of the most pertinent news broadcast. It's too coincidental. but I'll jump forward in time.
Me and my partner are Top Gun fighter pilots, the best of the best. Pew, pew,
pew. Oh man, my drugs are wearing off. Who's got more?
Tron?
What's Tron?
Presenting the real-life fairy tale of how Princess Annie was saved from bad neighborhood forest by woodsman Troy. And Bebed, his emotionally unavailable unicorn.
Abed, true to form, has decided to do the weird thing.
Abed is Batman now. Christian Bale.
It's official from the man himself. May I have that back, Annie? Thank you. And just to clarify, if you see this lying out, I'm still using it, so you don't have to take it to the kitchen, dump it out, and wash the bowl.
Is this about your buttered noodles?
I didn't say that. All right, I think I figured out the viewing order. Original version, director's cut with commentary, and then original version cooldown.
Yeah, we'll see.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, you guys, we've been robbed!
Oh man, I can't believe we got robbed.
Well, I guess the only upside to this is it's brought us closer together as roommates.
Something doesn't add up. If there was no forced entry, it had to be an inside job.
We don't know that.
And instead of taking cash, pharmaceuticals, laptops, they take what? My Batman DVD and one piece of oddly ornate Hebrew-themed jewelry?
Nana gave it.
It's smoke. It's a ruse. A lie. I think I know what happened here.
Well, not everybody's perfect, Abed.
Batman. And I am.
Well, Batman, on behalf of all of us that aren't perfect, can I just say, I'm sorry I broke your DVD.
Apology accepted. But I wouldn't mention it to Abed. That guy's pretty ruthless. And that's coming from Batman.
Hey, guys.
Abed, where have you been?
Troy, really?
Guys, found something we can watch together for Christmas this year. The long-lost 1981 Inspector Spacetime holiday special. Runtime 2.5 hours, and so critically reviled that after it aired, the creator had his knighthood revoked.
Glee! It's like a drug that you use that turns pain into shoes and your shoes into dance!
How's your piano still playing this song?
Glee! I'll understand every scene because they'll sing what they mean instead of making a face. Connoisseur of Christmas on the spectrum, none of your business.
Time day, Reggie. It is tradition to give one's constable a gift at the end of each orbital cycle.
Thank you, Inspector.
Blimey!
A hologram.
Mm-hmm.
Let's activate it and view the performance. I try to find a way around and get
behind your wall. I try to reach the top and find your wall. It's terrible.
I think I got this. Everyone just come and relax and behave normally.
That's the noise that people make when they're offended in all the movies that Annie rents.
We de-whimsified ourselves.
Yep, we're normal now.
Oh.
Abed.
Over break, Abed realized he could hire celebrity impersonators from a service for his own personal use. He's been doing it a lot.
He's not hurting anybody. He just likes reenacting scenes from movies. It's unquestionably awesome.
I question it. He spent New Year's locked in our bathroom with a bad Tom Hanks from Castaway.
I'll bet it was the volleyball.
Well, that makes sense. You guys, focus! Where's he getting the money for all this? Intervention? Intervention? Intervention?
No! You guys need to stop intervening. You seriously have a problem.
We can actually hurt Abed if every time he faces reality, we dress up and play make-believe to bail him out.
Shame on you people. It's not our job to help Abed grow up. Abed doesn't need reality. Abed is a magical, elf-like man who makes us all more magical by being near us.
It's your femur bone. He needs some money. He's broke. Okay.
Laughter's the best medicine.
What are you doing?
I'm challenging your entire medical establishment, sir.
Not you.
Are you mad at me?
No.
Cool. I was gonna go in the dreamatorium and play Inspector Spacetime.
Have fun. Abed.
Yeah?
Come here.
I am mad at you.
You said you weren't. We never lie.
I know.
We made a deal. October 15th, 2009. Friends don't lie to each other.
I know. I lied. Because you don't like people who tell you what to do, and I don't want to be one of those people.
Then don't be.
I have to be. You have to stop running celebrity impersonators. Vinny was going to break both of your legs. I had to work really hard to help you.
But that's what you wanted to do.
Yes.
But I can't do what I want to do?
I guess not. Not all the time. Sometimes you're just going to have to trust that I know better about stuff.
I don't know if I can do that.
Then I guess you're going to have to trust that you're going to have to trust me.
Well, I don't want to stop being your friend, so I guess I'll let you tell me what to do sometimes. Still best friends?
Yeah. Still best friends. Always.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Hi, Abed.
Hi. Where's Troy?
In the other room. That's okay. There are many advantages to traveling by yourself. You can drive faster, change direction, and the only pee breaks are yours. Are you real?
Are you?
This is really crazy. And inaccessible and maybe too dark. Maybe to them, but not to us. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Hot. Hot, hot, hot.
We'd have a better chance of setting the record if we made this a blanket fort. You know, take less time.
We wanted to make a pillow fort. I don't want to sacrifice quality for square footage. We don't need a world record to tell us we did something cool.
But if we won, we might meet that dude with the curly fingernails.
Shridhar Chilal? Not interested. I saw him on a talk show. He came off as pretentious. You should put the small ones in the middle of the wall, won't hold the ceiling.
Why do I always have to be your Reggie?
What?
I wanted to make a blanket fort, and you never even gave it a second thought. I'm not even your sidekick, I'm your underkick.
I never said you couldn't do anything. If you want to make a blanket fort, that's fine with me.
Thank you.
Just don't make it part of my pillow fort.
Bitches is devious.
Well, what are we gonna do here, guys? Is there a way we can connect them?
You can't connect the blanket fort to the pillow fort and still call it a pillow fort. Even if you could, I'd rather see my work destroyed than compromise it.
Great! Abed will destroy his pillow fort, and Troy will expand his blanket fort into the space. Everyone wins. Except Abed, but you know, not everyone can win.
Is that what you want, Troy? For me to destroy my pillow fort so you could set your record?
It is.
Magnitude! Evacuate Fort Abed and prepare for self-destruct.
Sir?
Do it. We're done here.
Pop, pop, Captain.
Prepare to initiate Protocol Omega. Bye, pillow fort. You were a beautiful dream.
More than a dream. It's here.
Who are you?
Someone who understands dedication to craftsmanship in the face of mediocrity. This world is run by the unremarkables. Don't do what you always do, Abed. Don't corrupt the host to pacify the parasites. Ask yourself, what if I stop worrying about their acceptance of me?
And his socially dysfunctional best friend turned bitter rival. An uncompromising tactical mastermind feared by all, yet unable to pay parking tickets or know left from right without mouthing the Pledge of Allegiance. Earlier that day, they begin...
The war won't stop with First Blood Part 2. It will escalate to Rambo 3, which should really be called Rambo 2 First Blood Part 3. But the Rambo titles never made sense. And neither does war. Abed Nadir. Facebook status update.
Hey, Dick. Read your dumb email. Really enjoyed it. Guess what? You may have been my best friend, but we both know I was your first friend. And what I know, but you don't know, because you have mental issues, is that you're never going to have another friend. Because, all caps, nobody else will ever have my patience with you. Troy Barnes, four-part text message.
Guys, can we maybe watch a different movie, or just stop saying that word 6 times per minute?
What word?
Late.
Because of Britta's ex-boyfriend.
Can you check my messages for me and tell me if he called? I don't think that's a good idea.
What if my mother died?
You guys are really talking over Blade.
Not cool.
Annie, subdue your guests.
Annie.
Boys' night.
I need help reacting to something.
I secretly switched Blade's number in her phone to my number. So if she tries to get in touch with him, it'll come to me.
That's diabolical.
Yeah.
Back to the matter at hand.
Y'all ever notice the difference between me and Troy brushing our teeth? I brush my teeth like this. Troy brushes his teeth like this.
I do.
I brush my teeth just like that.
I can't go to Senior Kevin's. The manager and I are enemies. He said Die Hard was bad.
I know, buddy.
Abed promised he'd show me how the dreamatorium works. Today's the perfect day for it.
But I want to...
Abed, don't you think today's the perfect day for it?
No.
Abed?
Is this a social cue?
I am Inspector Spacetime, and I know that which is unknown.
How do you know Troy and Britta pairing up wouldn't destroy everything? I run the scenarios. I examine this stuff from every conceivable angle.
Oh, and you can do that, but I can't? You don't have a patent on being a control freak, Abed.
I kinda do. This is the Dreamatorium's engine. My thoughts are collected by this box, and everything I know about my friends is stored here. Both are distilled by logic and then recombined into objective observation. I am able to simulate any of the study group and even a half-accurate Chang in over 7,000 unique situations.
Abed, it's cardboard tubes and a funnel. Well, he's fine. He always will be. People bend over backwards to cater to him.
He's just extra sensitive in the Dreamatorium.
Why don't you take all your thoughts and your logic and add one step to the process?
What are you doing?
From now on, before you do or say anything, you're gonna think about how it affects the people around you. We lower functioning brains call this empathy. Abed? You know how you wanted me to tell you when you were being scary weird instead of cute weird? This is scary weird. Dr. Jeff? Can you-
Abed's been filtered out because nobody needs him.
I need him.
Well, you're not simulated.
No, but this is. Oh!
Meta.
It's Abed! I got an Abed here! Get him!
That's it. I find you guilty of being Abed. You're under arrest!
Can I just interject and say I don't know what the hell's going on?
Abed? Abed?
Yeah! I found you by turning into you. How cool is that?
Cool.
Tell me where we are so I can pretend to see it.
We're inside a locker. It's where I spent a lot of time in junior high. It's a metaphorical locker. It's a place where people like me get put when everyone's finally fed up with us.
My point is, your simulations are nothing more than anxieties. You're afraid you don't fit in. You're afraid you'll be alone. Great news! You share that with all of us, so you'll never be alone, and you'll always fit in.
I could take up yoga.
You have the body type. Now.
I am Abed Nadir, and I don't know a lot of things everyone else knows. I'm hungry. Are you hungry?
Yeah.
I'll make us buttered noodles.
And?
Actually, boys, I have a little surprise for you. While you two were out playing laser tag.
That's laser tag with sport coats.
I did a little extreme bedroom makeover. I unbunked your beds and got scrap fabric and...
It's okay, buddy. We can put it back. We can put it back the way it was. It's okay. Cut, Garrett.
I'm sorry.
Why don't we ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
We're to zoom in there. There's a clock on the wall.
8 + 2 × 5.
10 after 8.
I'm gifted in other ways.
Greendale and the school board. Greendale 7.
See? Cool. Abed brought delicious police.
Abed, what happened?
Found your friend going through the dumpster outside the administration building in Greendale again.
This cadet could use a lesson in intergalactic protocol.
If this were Comic-Con, I'd take a bullet for that kid. But here in the real world, trespassing is a crime.
We're sorry, officer. Our friend has been having a hard time adjusting to being expelled from Greendale.
It's the number for a psychiatrist. What? No! Abed's not crazy. Where does the dean get off?
Abed? I'm Dr. Heidi. We're going to have a little chat tonight, you and I. How does that sound?
I don't need therapy.
Well, that's a perfectly normal response.
Abed won't go to any kind of doctor on his own. We caught him last year trying to remove his own tonsils.
Well, why don't you let me take it from here?
You have to understand about Abed. He's usually, you know, adorable weird, like Mork from Mork. But since we got expelled, he's been creepy weird, like present-day Robin Williams.
I'm not crazy.
Well, Abed, I don't deal in crazy. I deal in help. So how long has Abed needed a crazy amount of help? All of this behavior started after you were expelled?
There may have been a ramp up.
It's okay, buddy.
Just a few more minutes and we're good until spring, okay?
But it doesn't make any sense.
Think of it this way. We'll get the hour back later in the year.
I rented Tower Heist last night, and I will not spoil the end of it. Let me tell you, it was quite the hilarious thrill ride. That Brett Ratner, he's a master at comedic action adventure. A master at storytelling. He's just a master at making movies in general. You know, I'm gonna say it. He's the new Spielberg.
I have to go. You're a bad person.
You're a bad person.
Time enough at last to eat a sandwich. Though even he knew that this sandwich was nearer his last sandwich than his first.
Hey, Abed, I'm trying to eat.
He said, oldly.
If anything, Abed's more sane than any of us.
Yeah, well.
And assuming that this group is for Abed, said support system, I think I've heard everything I need to hear in order to make a decision. I think that Abed should be committed.
You mean committed to his character work, right? Because he already is. Abed, show him you're Don Draper.
Cigarettes.
No, I mean an institution.
You mean like marriage?
I mean a mental institution.
Ah, so do I.
Will someone please help me lighten the mood?
Please, Mr. Doctor, psychiatrist, sir. Please don't send my best friend to crazy people jail.
Relax, he doesn't have the right. Abed's not dangerous.
Yeah, he's just unique, like a snowflake. Who gets bent out of shape when you mix up Star Wars and Space Treks.
What Pierce was saying before he started sundowning is true. We can't just pass the crazy buck to Greendale. It could be a good place, too. You know what occurs to me? What all those great Greendale memories have in common?
I was barely in them.
They were all about Dean Pelton.
That's what I've been trying to make you guys understand for the last 2 months. I keep telling you, we weren't expelled by the real Dean. Couldn't have been him. He loved us.
After you squandered the last of your savings, I'll watch you ride penniless in the gutter through a telescope in the penthouse office of Hawthorne Tower. You can leave notes. The scheme is incredible.
I have information on the following topics.
Holy crap, where have you been my whole life? This is so cool. Where are your clothes?
Pierce taught me poker. I'm not good at it. You still talking to this girl?
Yeah, she only has three moods that you activate with basic patterns of stimulus. I've never felt this way before.
Abed, don't get weird.
Oh, I won't. She's not ready for anything serious. But she wants me to meet her family.
My father is a blacksmith.
Her father's a blacksmith.
We were just saying goodbye to Abed.
I'm gonna stay here in the village with Hilda and help her rebuild her life.
Abed, she's a program.
People have said similar things about me.
Uh-oh. He's playing the Rain Man card. Let's bounce. I've got an inheritance to win.
Abed!
You remember Hilda.
I live in the village. I love Abed.
Did she just say your name?
Yeah, if you max out a character's trust and affection levels, you can gain access to a front-end scripting language. Watch. She can make babies for me.
Oh, and I can't. I can't.
Oh, Abed, but...
Annie, let's find the Tin Man's heart later.
Apologize for him.
Oh, that's okay. He's family.
Hilda, my love, I said I'd come back for you.
All right, let's go.
Abed, what did he say to you?
He said, I know you hate when people do this in movies. Sorry, I got emotional. Hey, Abed. This can't be good. Abed. I'm not talking to you because I'm not crazy. Think of it as inner dialogue. I'm reading the novelization of Chronicles of Riddick. Can you honestly tell me that's a saner decision? You're worried you'll go crazy without Troy. That's why you're gonna let Britta fix you, right? Because you think you're broken, you're gonna get diagnosed by someone who said her favorite superhero was X-Man. I'm a little scared. Things are bad. When the world gets bad enough, Abed, the good go crazy. But the smart, they go bad. Come on in here. Let's talk about it. I think it's safer if I talk to Britta. I think it's even safer if I talk to her first.
Ah, now we're getting somewhere. I think lame Abed sent you to talk because you're more equipped to deal with fear.
That's the lame way of seeing it, yes.
By the way,
I'm so sorry.
It doesn't matter, Abed. I should have never played therapist with you. I'll change my major just one more time.
But you can't. You cured me. I mean, I'm not cured. I'm willing to admit I definitely need therapy. And you're the only kind of shrink I could ever trust. The kind with as little control over my mind as me. Yep.
Did you go to your happy place?
Yeah.
Did you envision a babbling brook like I described?
I started out with a babbling brook, but then I layered in elements from our world. I'm sure fans of the babbling brook will complain, but I felt it was limiting.
Well, it's best to keep it simple.
It was a babbling brook.
Abed, you ready for our last first day of school?
You ready, buddy?
I just need a minute. This is my show. It's about me and all my friends. This Happy Community College show is filmed before a live audience inside of my head.
We have to make this year count, especially since it's the last one.
I took some extra classes online, and I'm one history credit away from graduating.
Jeff, you're graduating early?
Well,
are you sure?
Yeah, I'm fine.
F-I-N-E or F-Y-N-E? We made one of them a code for not fine.
Oh. F-Y-N-E.
Okay, he's fine. Let's go.
But I think the fairest way to handle this is to have everyone repeat the last 3 years.
You can't be serious.
Indeed, I am.
We're gonna be here forever. 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 Forever.
I'm gonna stand here forever.
All these balls. I'm so close I can taste it.
After just one forensics class, I found a way to retrieve our student records. It turns out there's a backup, and it's in a safe.
Oh. Here, one more ball to go, but it's another dance contest, so I think I got it. What's wrong with Abed?
No, don't open the safe. We're redoing our first 3 years. That's what I want.
It's okay, Abed. Here's a trick I use when I feel overwhelmed. Just imagine a happy place and then go there.
Is he in his imagination emporium?
Dreamatorium? Mm-hmm. No, this seems like something new. Abed was having some anxiety about all the changes this year, so I may have told him to go to a happy place in his mind.
You told him to go somewhere? In his mind? Do you realize who you told that to?
Hey, guys.
That even if we go somewhere, we're not going anywhere.
That was a killer speech, Jeff.
I didn't say anything. I literally just walked up.
I know. I made the speech for you. It hit all the right notes. I was trying to hang on to this moment because I was so afraid of the future. But then I realized all of this was once the future. And it was completely different from what I'd known before. And it was happening so fast. But in the end, or in the now, I guess, it turned out great.
And Andre is going as Han Solo.
Aww.
The boys are stormtroopers and little baby Ben is an Ewok.
Aww.
Oh, you don't have enough children. Does Vicky have a TV?
Abed, it's a party. You're not watching TV.
We don't want to go over the same area twice, so be thorough.
Thorough, got it.
Give it here!
I remember when this show was about a community college. Are you watching Inspector Spacetime?
Why does he have to wake up so early? Can't we just tell Abed that we're sleeping together?
No. Abed's fragile. We have to ease him into it, okay? Do we want him to freak out and then we have to rescue him from some fantasy world where submarines are small enough to enter the bloodstream? I totally want to do that.
We need to go over the convention schedule again.
Troy!
I've printed out several maps of the convention center and color-coded the best potential routes. Now, we know I have longer stride, but I'm assuming your superior physical fitness will allow you to compensate with greater speed. One thing's for sure, though, we need to save time by changing into our costumes in the car.
Haha, yeah.
I know you two are having sex. I've known for weeks.
What? Why didn't you say something?
I love donuts.
Who?
Wait, was there a female inspector?
Yes, and everyone hates her. Not because they're sexist, because she sucks.
Well, I think it's cool.
Right on.
Annie!
You're on your own, Al Capone.
Everyone's entitled to their own opinion.
Am I the only one freaked out by that?
What?
We wanted it to be a surprise.
You bear a striking resemblance to Inspector Spacetime supervillain, Thoraxis.
Who's Toby?
Toby Weeks, arguably the biggest Inspector Spacetime fan in the world. We've been emailing for months.
Oh, you never mentioned him.
Well, you've been so busy lately having sex. Besides, we talked about embracing change, so I'm expanding my social circle.
Someone might just happen to have a pair of tickets to the sold-out panel.
Toby, did you see
the Christmas special? Horrible.
But when you consider what it set up...
Brilliant.
Oh,
is that... Let's go.
Do they even have to talk? They could just touch tentacles and download.
Oh, this is so nice. Just three friends, friending around.
Troy's been acting weird lately.
The same thing happened with my constable when he got a wife. Which means, of course, I now have one spare ticket to the 50th anniversary Inspector Spacetime convention in London.
Demisen Inspecticon? But it's so soon, and London's too far.
In England, Cadbury cream eggs are sold year-round.
I thought that was just a legend.
I can't wait. And we can visit the original Spacetime sets, and I've got a spare bedroom, so you can stay as long as you like.
Oh, that all sounds great. But I don't know if I can just pick up and leave. I have life here.
For now.
What do you mean?
Well, let's face it, neurotypicals don't have the same focus you or I have. They always get distracted. My marriage, kids, competitive cooking shows.
David doesn't actually exist, does he?
You're mad. Nothing you've said can prove that.
Except that when we met, you said his name was Andrew.
Bollocks. When you sent me that first email in which you figured out that Inspector Spacetime is both his own grandfather and grandmother, I knew we were soulmates. You and I are special. Neurotypicals won't admit it, but some people are just better than everybody else.
But maybe there's a reason the Inspector always chooses a human companion. He's an alien, but his human friends keep him grounded and invested in the world, like with me and Troy. If I could winger you for a second?
Sure, I don't know what that means, but...
Maybe all relationships are made up of logical inspectors and emotional constables, and we need both to make space and time a better place. Wait, Toby, just give me a second. You have to let me out!
No, not until Stockholm Syndrome sets in. How long do you think that'll be? A couple of hours? Would you love me if I got you a churro?
You know who Troy is! Yeah. Troy will find me.
You okay?
I am. You know, for the first time in my long history of being locked inside things, I knew someone would come. Still want to take the glow-on photo?
What do you think?
Yes.
Yes.
And I have a surprise for you guys.
Really pushing me here.
He's back.
There's only one way to find out.
I hate you. I just felt a strange disturbance.
Did you have dairy this morning?
Could be that. Or it could be that great evil's nearby. I'll take a provisional lactate. Dr. Blitz. Knight of the Atlantis Guild, wielder of the four-pronged trident and spawncraft.
How did you know?
I recognize your catchphrase. Tonight we dine in hell! I'm Spacetimer 8032.
You are Spacetimer 8032?
The one and only.
It's wonderful to meet you, brother.
Everybody think we're the bad guys.
We are. When Carl and I were raiding the Diamond North Caves, I was facing 50 death beetles. I would have perished for sure, but he saved me. Then when I had a chance to return the favor, I looked him in the eye and I told him it was solid cake. There's probably a way I can make it up to him. Maybe I'll give him my four-pronged trident.
Why don't you call it a quadrident?
Shh. I was gonna microwave buttered noodles, but this sounds equally promising. I'm in. Oh, I brought something.
Ooh.
Dip.
Oh, Abed, why is this 7-layer dip so puffy?
Oh, it's been in the fridge for 2 years.
I'm saving it for a special occasion.
Oh, that's so thoughtful. I'm going to put this on a nice platter with some crackers in the trash. Where's Britta?
It's a reference. That's my humor. Abed gets it.
Oh. Bennett lockup was not where we belonged. We belonged in the sun with the wind in our hair. Something about shackles on his heart. To be honest, I stopped listening. I was thinking about Christmas. I hope we do Die Hard. I hope it's in a restaurant. I hope it lays out as cleanly as it does in my dreams. I hope it's cool. Cool, cool, cool.
Cheers.
Doubtful. When he's alone, he mostly just practices smiling and frowning. We've all done it. Thanks. A lot of filmmakers use crane shots to elicit emotion. College dean threatening a fraternity. You'll never shut down the Delta Cubes.
What?
Delta Cubes. Delta Cubes. Placating students with a fun event. Classic bread and circuses. In ancient Rome, the emperor would distract the populace from their problems by allocating money for free bread and circuses. I've been making a conscious effort to get away from filtering everything through TV. I figured it's time I showed some growth. It's been 3.5 seasons, is what the old me would have said. Oh. Where's this going?
Can I set you up with a date for the Sadie Hawkins Day dance?
A blind date. I've always thought of myself as more of an acquired taste, but... Okay.
Oh, if you're open to meeting someone, there's a number of eligible young ladies in my church.
Surely, I'm already finding a date for Abed. I asked first.
There's no reason we can't both help Abed find someone. Why don't we each pick a girl and then let Abed decide instead of making it a competition?
That's exactly a competition.
So it is.
Only for the loser.
Abed, this is Kat.
Hi, Kat. Nice to meet you.
She wants to ask you something. Isn't she perfect for Abed? She's like one of those quirky girls from the movies. I asked if you'd go to the Sadie Hawkins dance with me into the balloon. Could you hear it?
Sure, I'd be happy to go with you.
Super duper, Mr. Cooper.
At the risk of discovering I'm living two parallel lives like that guy in Awake, don't you already have a date to the dance?
Yep, now I have two, which means I could do the classic 2 dates in 1 night sitcom trope. I'll get to wear 2 outfits, mix up their names, maybe hide under a table.
But what about growth?
I tried to go in a more grounded direction, but I still ended up in a comically implausible situation. It's like Shirley said, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for hijinks. Here, in lieu of flowers, I got you this. It's quirky.
Except you gotta lose the hat. It doesn't go with the minister's daughter.
You know what I'm doing?
Yeah, you're on 2 dates at once. I've been watching you since you came in.
I'm not good with faces. Is that a judgmental face or a happy face?
I think it's awesome.
So this thing's turning out to be a little tougher than I thought. You want help?
I'd like to, but I still got like 1,200 pages left of this Bible. Yes, of course I would.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool.
Oh, sorry. If this were a movie, this would be the part where we kiss.
You're right. Except we're doing a sitcom trope, so it would be totally out of place. Time to go get caught and make an impassioned plea to the girl I really like. I think I'm gonna go with Jessica. She seems to be the audience favorite. Okay, bye. Let me explain.
What about wanting to grow? Or was that just a lie so you could do another world-famous Abed TV adventure? These are real people you're messing with. Kat is over there hula-hooping all by herself.
Abed, in the real world, people can actually get hurt.
But the girl I liked all along was under my nose. And now I screwed things up. I don't know if I can make them right.
Aww. Wait. This one's real, right?
Yeah, I'm really sad.
Aww. Well, go find her, dummy.
Yeah, haven't you ever seen a movie?
All right, Sophie. I have something to say. There was a girl here tonight. Her name was Rachel. I met her and it was very pleasant. And I made a mistake. And now I'd very much like to continue this conversation in private.
Yeah, and I don't need a puppet to express myself. I already say whatever I want.
Wait, Abed, you never told us your secret.
Oh, that's right.
I didn't share one that night. After we got back from the woods, everyone was being silent and not making eye contact. I didn't know why, so I mirrored your behavior.
Aww.
Hmm.
Dang.
So this is Christmas. Just this. I was hoping we could do Die Hard in a restaurant. There's a place called Nakatomi Sushi. I hear the Hans Gruber is to die for. Come on, people. It's all spelled out in your Evites. I know you opened them. Oh, I brought gifts. Does Annie live here now?
Do anything wrong.
I work really hard.
Hey, Abed, got you an early Christmas gift. I know you were bummed about not doing Die Hard in a restaurant. And your recent divorce.
To Abed, yippee-ki-yay, Father Christmas.
I tried to get you taking off shoes, but I didn't know how to wrap it.
John McClane's tank top? You're getting really good at Christmas, Troy.
We'd all heard about your...
Well, how about you, the odd, emotionless Muslim?
I mean, come on, you don't deserve an F. And you know that because of your impairment, they'll forgive you anyway.
All true, but I'm probably not your best target. If you don't mind, I'd like to get some popcorn. Typically, it takes a while for villains to ramp up. Promise not to monologue till I get back?
Give...
I missed something great, didn't I?
Wait!
Oh my God. Jeff, do you have any milk duds?
Buttered noodles.
My favorite. Freaky Friday. Oh, Troy, you are so thoughtful. I wish I had the capacity for sentimentality like you do.
Me? I wish I was more like you. No emotional hang-ups, endless cool adventures. You have it so easy.
No, you do, Troy.
No, you do, Abed. I wish I could switch places with you for just one day.
Shirley, did you ever date Roger Ebert?
Excuse me?
Nothing. Berta, did you ever take pictures of your feet and post them on the internet for money?
Yeah, no.
Guys, this history final...
Abed, we don't have origin stories. We have lives. Abed, I know it's disappointing to you, but we're not superheroes. This is the real world, not some comic book adventure.
Pierce Hawthorne, fixture at Greendale, unavoidable. Hey, is that a sad face?
I wouldn't know. This is good. This is really great. We're really filling in some plot holes here. It's good stuff. It's really good. Have I missed something?
There.
Because I had to go to school here. Abed, do not write that down.
I had to smile when I didn't feel like smiling.
If only I didn't have to pick up my kids at the mall, I could...
Wait. When? Which mall? Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Hey!
What movie are you guys gonna see?
The Phantom Menace. It's kind of old.
And why do you want to see it?
Because we like Star Wars.
Okay. If you like Star Wars, why do you want to murder it and urinate on its grave? The prequels are terrible. I mean, seriously, wouldn't Chewbacca at some point go, "Hey, Yoda, I know that guy."
He has double lightsabers.
That's stupid. You're both stupid. This can't be. I don't see why I have to go to a therapist.
Because after that woman chewed them out for 3 hours, the theater got a restraining order against you.
Hey, Doc. By the way, someone just stole your prescription pad. All this time, I wondered what it was that brought our group together. But I forgot one thing all heroes need. They need an enemy. And this study group has me. I'm the supervillain. Why didn't I see it before? I'm emotionless, logical, smarter than everybody else.
Hey!
I tried sawing off Jeff's arm.
Why do you keep saying that?
I should go. It's not safe to be around me. Just 10 minutes ago, I would have been so excited about that peeing thing. I wanted to make a prequel, and I ruined everything. I guess it could happen to anyone. I should probably write George Lucas a note of apology.
Okay, let's not get crazy.
Walk over there right now and apologize to the theater manager.
Midichlorians. Midichlorians.
Fine. Then you are not going to film school.
That weird guy hasn't blinked once.
Oh, yeah. What a dweeb.
Yeah, what a dweeb. Oh, nice shot, man.
Everyone should have the same chance, don't you think? Chang?
It's not Chang. It's Kevin. How long have you known?
Known what? Only you know who you really are. Also, you may have experimental monkey fever.
We'll roll for it.
It didn't land on a number. That probably means nothing.
Hello, Abed.
Hello, evil Jeff.
What? How did you...
I may not be good with facial expressions, but I know an evil doppelganger when I see one. Plus, your arm makes a noise every time you move it.
Silence!
Is anyone here? Hello, Abed. Welcome to our home. Hello, evil Abed. It's just Abed now. After we met, I abandoned my evil goal to focus on brightening my own timeline instead. Do you live here alone?
Yes.
That's why he forced me to show him how to travel between timelines. My God. This is so cool.
I know.
Kind of a Superman 3 meets that Star Trek episode meets season 3 of The Cape. The Cape was canceled. Not here. They retooled it for cable, and it's awesome. Want to see it? Desperately. But I need to get back to my timeline and stop evil Jeff. So I came to the only person who could help me. Me.
I'll get you home, Abed. But first... you'll need some supplies.
Why don't I just give him what he wants?
What? You can't give up now.
Why not?
Because it's not real. Look around, Jeff. Haven't you noticed the vending machines are full of meats and hard-boiled eggs? So part of you wants Evil Jeff to win, because then you could go backwards and pretend you're the same guy you were 4 years ago, but you're not. You're stronger. You're better. You have friends. No, screw that. You have a family.
Wait. If this is all my mind, then I don't really need to fight him.
Don't logic this one away from me. We finally figured out a way to make paintball cool again.
You know, just to settle group arguments about who misses me the most.
Oh.
I see your value now.
Abed, why?
I see your value now. It's a callback to when we met first season. And me calling you your seasons is a callback to my first season dialogue. And me calling
Abed, I know what makes you off-putting, but why are you here? You're programming now, Abed? Didn't get any work with your 4-year film degree?
One job, directing a commercial. Still haven't been paid.
I'll cut you a check tomorrow. But just so we're clear, you quit.
Creative differences.
I asked you to put the phone number on the screen.
I didn't like the number. 555, it's derivative.
It's the number of my business.
It sounds fake. How can every number start with 555? Are there only 10,000 numbers? I've been spending so much time with computers, your tears are just ones and zeros to me.
Yeah, you were a real Hallmark card before. After being rehired as a security guard, after being fired for impersonating a teacher.
That's insane. And I'm Abed. I'd like to take the study room table and back and burn it.
Burn it? Why?
The same reason I never returned Time Bandits to Blockbuster. Nobody else deserves it.
It's a place that you can do it.
You got a job teaching here, didn't you?
I don't want to talk about it.
A film degree doesn't make me a filmmaker. I need to learn how to work with other people.
Table mark 2?
I added that and a few custom upgrades. It's voice activated. Table, resume table mode. Table, power down.
Wait, I got a cup on there.
I certainly hope you'll be a better teacher than him.
About an actor who keeps the world asking, Nicolas Cage, good or bad? Yes, young man.
So you don't know?
Mr. Nadir drove our TV studies professor out of his mind by proving that there was an answer to the question, who's the boss?
Angela.
I admire your brain, Mr. Nadir. I did not admire Professor Sheffield, but I promise you, this question has no answer. Your homework is to watch 5 Nicolas Cage films by Wednesday.
He's a complex performer. He'll give you The Rock, Con Air, then Face Off, and you think you understand. But then Wind Talkers, Guarding Test, The Wicker Man, he begs you to stop watching, but you can't. But is he good or is he bad? Every actor is something. Robert Downey Jr., good. Jim Belushi, bad. Van Damme, the good kind of bad. Johnny Depp, the bad kind of good. There's a spectrum, and Cage is on it. I just have to find him. Okay, hey, I have a working theory, and don't react until you've heard the whole thing. If you watch closely at the 7-minute mark in Snake Eyes, you'll notice the moment where an alien arm could have come up and...
Abed, this isn't worth it. Maybe Nicolas Cage is just crazy.
All actors are crazy, Annie. Some crazy actors are good, some are bad, but none of them are neither. There's no such thing as both. So which one is Nicolas Cage, huh?
Dear God.
Go,
stand back. Give him space.
Nicolas Cage, good or bad? A challenge, certainly, but not unsolvable, because all actors have distinct values, which I use to find answers.
Abed, how much Nicolas Cage did you...
Enough! I watched enough to find the answers, because this is my reality. This is how I learned to be, and my being doesn't allow for Nicolas freaking Cage, okay?
Abed, think of something safe, like Holly Hunter or Don Cheadle.
Abed, I couldn't find you at school, so I got worried. You're throwing away all your little movies. Why?
They have no value anymore.
Well, if you're looking for something to believe in, I know a skinny little Hebrew handyman you could meet.
I'm not going to become Christian, Shirley, or a better Muslim. This was my religion. I thought the meaning of people was somewhere in here. Then I looked inside Nicolas Cage and I found a secret. People are random and pointless.
Well, in my religion, the whole point is that you can't understand every little thing, and You know, there's a word for people who remind you that you're not God and invite you to try a little harder.
Prophets, messiahs, kung fu pandas. So Nicolas Cage is Jesus?
No. But he clearly works in mysterious ways, and maybe that's just his job.
And that's why critics can call him a genius or an idiot and be right no matter what.
A demon to some and an angel to others, like a Cenobite.
Excuse me, did you say Cenobite?
Yeah, you know Cenobite, like from Hellraiser.
You like Hellraiser. You know the word Hellraiser.
I thought Pinhead in space was a bit of a letdown, but I'm in for the ride.
Will you stop with the cuffs and the blankets?
This is how they comfort victims in movies.
Okay.
Abed, you're special. Can't you just stand at the scene of the crime and see what happened?
I see a man using a social disorder as a procedural device. Wait, I see another man. Mildly autistic super detectives everywhere. Basic cable, broadcast networks, pain. Painful writing. It hurts.
Mr. Nadir, state your name.
Abed Nadir.
Have you ever 9/11 anyone?
Nope.
When you were a child, did you ever kill a squirrel with a slingshot and were surprised that you felt nothing and wondered if you were capable of doing it to a human?
No.
Mr. Barnes, did you invent that handshake? Yes?
Lie.
Mr. Barnes, are you a subscriber to the video blog Fun for Friends?
No.
Lie.
Silence, wench!
Hi, I'm Kevin, this is Kyle, and here's a fun handshake you could do with your best friend. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to rate us, comment, and subscribe.
Can't look at you right now.
Then you should know I'm crying.
I forgive you, but only to escape the established pattern of self-righteous indignation followed by immediate comeuppance.
Mr. Nadir.
Okay, I guess it's happening anyways. You broke my heart. Continue.
Is it true that you planted geo-trafficking devices on everyone in the group so that you would know where they are at all times?
Yes. Okay, you guys are changing your faces. Are you mad at me or hungry?
You're tracking us? We're mad at you, Abed.
Why?
Because we already live in a totalitarian surveillance state. Do you not read my status updates?
But I'm not the government. I'm your friend.
That's what governments say, Nimrod.
It's cool. When one of you gets kidnapped, you'll be glad you don't have to count the bumps on the highway from the trunk of a car.
Are those blinking dots us?
Mm-hmm.
What's this one all the way to the side?
That's where Pierce is buried.
Is that why you were spending so much time by the coffin?
I was trying to get it back. They're expensive, and he's not moving anymore.
I know you know. It's wrong to do that without telling us. Shame on you!
Okay, I'm ashamed. Lie. I'm a bad person for tracking your location, but you altered my brain chemistry. I was up for 3 days that week. I invented an entire language, you flitz barping gits gorg.
I'm sorry.
You messed with my brain. That's a big deal. This is a big deal. I don't mess with your brain, Annie.
I bore my soul to you. I told you about my holding hands at Disneyland fantasy. Do you care about people at all, Abed? Answer on the polygraph.
Jeff made me apply for handicapped parking so he can get a better spot. When any of you chew gum, I want to punch you. You may as well have submachine guns in your mouths. It vibrates my skull.
Abed Nadir, did you know that you were insane and nothing that you said ever made any sense to me?
Yep.
Here's your sperm.
Cool. Cool, cool, cool.
That's a lie.
Attention, Green Bay!
Announcement!
I'm standing here
with Abed Nadir, who has chosen to give his best friend Troy the very special going away present of declaring a school-wide game of hot lava.
Stand down or meet your doom, Chang.
I don't want my last day here to be a day where everyone hates me.
Last day?
Left her for dead?
Sounds bad when you put it that way. Can you put it away that sounds good?
Ow!
Sorry about our butts touching. Okay, we'll go into the vents. They'll never find us there.
I say we take a stand here. I mean, someone's gotta win sometime.
Not if we never kill each other. Then we can play forever.
Right. Wait, Abed, the floor can't be lava forever. The game's gotta end.
It's not a game for me, Troy. I'm seeing real lava because you're leaving. It's embarrassing. And I don't want to be crazy, but I am crazy, so I made a game that made you and everyone else see what I see. I don't want it to be there either, I swear. I want you to be able to leave, but I don't think the lava goes away until you stop leaving.
So the only way I can help you is by giving up my chance to be one person? Guys, stop, okay? The lava's real to Abed. It's not a game to him.
Oh, no.
You know what I think? I think he's used to getting his own way. I think he's never met me.
Abed! Abed! Abed, give me your other hand!
It's down to us. You or Britta will be the winner.
I'm not leaving, okay? I promise. The floor's not lava now. Just give me your hand.
I don't think the lava's here because you're leaving. I think it's here because I won't let go. Sorry. Bye.
Abed! 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 He's fake dead. You don't get it. No one gets Abed. I got him a little. This is my fault. It worked.
We made a perfect clone of Abed.
Actually, Britta's work was sloppy. I'm not an exact replication. I have all of Abed's abilities and memories, but I'm missing his wild emotionality. Although I think I may be able to let Troy go now.
I don't know. I haven't been completely honest. I'm really scared to go on my trip.
Well, you don't have to go. Your clone can.
Right.
Clone Troy?
Clone Abed?
By the way, when I cloned you, I had to patch some missing parts of your DNA with genes from a homing pigeon. You may notice side effects, like a compulsion to come back.
Cool. Clone hug?
Popular that watching them is no longer a statement.
So because you're three seasons behind, we have to live in a fantasy world where there's no such thing as dragons? Do we also have to pretend that Lord Stavarius is still alive?
Thanks, Abed. How about I buy all the Bloodlines of Conquest books, read ahead, and spoil the whole series for you?
That's insane. That's something an insane person would do. Hello, I'm taking a school census. Please fill out this form, but don't talk to me. I can't hear. Are you deaf? But you read lips? Barba, garba, garba. Garba, barba, barba. That was gibberish. You're good. I wish I knew sign language.
Come on. What?
God.
To the spoiler goes the victory.
But I really liked her.
She probably likes you too, but she also likes cash.
I'm devastated.
No, I feel bad. But you learned a lesson, and I gave a differently abled person a job.
Hello. I'm gonna crash the premiere of the Kickpuncher reboot dressed like classic Kickpuncher. They shouldn't have redesigned that costume. Keep your heads in the sand if you want.
Cool.
I know this is bad timing, but I should go if I'm gonna make the movie, so. What are you doing?
Oh, something nobody ever does. Teaching you consequences.
But I have to go.
But you can't. Huh? Isn't that crazy? You ever been grounded? You ever been punished? Do you have any idea what it feels like to be refused something?
I know what it feels like when people try to control me. You should know it never goes their way.
Ooh. And what kicky punch movie is that from? The ones you've seen? Or the one I'm gonna watch you miss?
I said I was sorry.
I'm sorry I punched my landlord, but I'm not getting my deposit back.
That's an example of you being punished for choosing to hurt someone. I wrecked your papers by accident.
You chose to spray this crap on purpose because you didn't care what happened. Let me tell you something. For 5 years, I have watched people walk around on your eggshells. Oh, Abed, he's so imaginative, so magical. Everybody hide the hamburgers. If Abed sees a hamburger, we'll all travel in time. Let's eat cookies and ice cream and dress in pajamas in the middle of the day. I watched my third wife die.
You think I'm spoiled? And you think I'm spoiled because it's never occurred to anyone to do this? You're not the Marco Polo of bullying me. You're just another tourist taking pictures of a great big wall. Looked like you were doodling chickens.
He is a duck!
Uh-oh.
And what were you before this? Were you normal? Or do you act like this because somebody stuffed you in a locker? Is that the idea?
Other way around. I'm a real jerk for wrecking it.
You didn't do it on purpose.
That doesn't excuse my behavior.
I appreciate that.
Yes, the lesson being that you're very talented, but I have this thing. I can't walk into a movie after...
You're not going to the movie.
Yes, I am.
You need this.
Let me go.
This is you learning.
You're a bad person and a bad cartoonist.
You go ahead. Hurt my feelings.
Oh, you have feelings, huh? Have you considered putting them into your work? Your cartoons are monuments to joylessness, nervously assembled jokes based on nothing from your life or anyone's life. You're furious at me for being creative because you want to be able to create. You have all this rage and shame and loneliness, which I don't even know how to feel, much less understand, and you decide to put what on paper? A duck. Jim the Duck. You think I'm crazy? You think there's something wrong with me? Jim the Duck?
Publishers are interested.
Oh, yeah, well, publishers are stupid. Either that or you're misinterpreting what was probably a form letter.
You shut up.
No,
you shut up.
Or are we yelling right now? Yelling, I'm yelling. You're not talented. You made me miss my movie. You made me miss my movie. In the words of your hacky duck, what the hell?
What are you doing here?
I want to show you something.
What's this?
It's a script I wrote about a cop on the edge. Troy thought it was hilarious. I don't have the heart to tell him it wasn't a comedy.
Why are you giving this to me?
I know all the tricks and tropes of filmmaking, but what I'm missing is what I think the critics call substance.
It's time for justice. Police justice. Wait. The character's name is Police Justice?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I may be able to help. You drank scotch?
No.
You're gonna.
You don't like my face?
Aww.
Other.
Meow meow beans.
You know.
No, it's effectively stupid. There already was a rating system in place called Cool People Get More, and it was working fine.
Meow meow beans takes everything subjective and unspoken about human interaction and reduces it to explicit and objective numbers. I've never felt more alive.
As long as you're happy, I'm unsettled.
Abed, hey, hey, come here.
Those are other threes. We talk about how we're glad we're not twos. Small talk, guys. I make small talk now.
Is she always so different?
If you talk to me, I can't concentrate on the dance moves. You're putting me on the spot. I guess my knee-jerk concern would be that he's a Viking and might only use our home as a temporary base before moving inland where lumber is more plentiful.
Is it cool if I poop?
No, Anthony, just cut the carrots. I've been dating Rachel for a month.
I don't think you heard his question. The answer is yes. Can we discuss this later? Rachel's on her way and I'd like to practice my smile. Who wants to play pile of bullets?
Not me.
You have to. Oh, it's okay. We don't have to.
It's not okay. We do have to. We all have to. And one day we'll tell you why.
But for now, let's simply retire to the TV area.
For the highest stakes, 1993 interactive VCR game of your entire young adult lives.
I don't want to die.
Stop her, Rachel. Stop her.
Bang?
No, bid five.
Oh, come on. Son of a bitch.
Me too.
No, we have to play again.
Abed, I think you're having one of your special times, okay? So I'm going to give you some space.
No, I don't want space. I want you to move in here.
What?
But that's not resolved. Anthony might move in. So.
Hey.
Hi. I'm here to do my third act apology.
Abed, I don't think...
Wait. Don't reject it until the whole thing's been served up. Dobra. Open your locker, please. Hey.
Hey.
I want to tell you something.
Abed, this is adorable.
Just because it's adorable doesn't mean it's not important. Listen. I've been accelerating our relationship because I've been worried I wouldn't pass a lot of the tests. I wanted you to move in because I thought if Annie was around, I'd have less chance of screwing things up. But the problem with me will always be that I can never know for sure. There's not a huge amount of people in my life that haven't eventually kicked me out, and I don't always see it coming. I don't want it to happen with you.
Well, don't manipulate me and don't keep secrets from me, and we'll probably be okay.
Cool.
It stopped raining.
Yeah, sure did. Was everyone's takeaway from last time that we can use D&D to reprogram brains? Nobody feels that we almost caused a suicide?
We prevented one.
And here we go. Yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna head across the bridge, actually. I mean, what else is out there? What's south or east or west? How about a disease? If I walk too far south, do I fall off your graph paper there?
You can head south. I've generated some details about the surrounding area.
If I kill the necrophile before you do...
I'm gonna go check on the others. You might want to check your character, or just kind of generally take this game seriously. Your son does.
Man, your friend sure can talk.
Liar, he'll never turn.
Oh, yeah, because of that famous goblin loyalty. I could never drive a wedge between you and some guy from work.
Nah, I was best man at that guy's wedding.
Oh? Klang doesn't approve of you and Lisa Goldbeck, and I don't get the sense it's because of his feelings for you. Come on, between you and me, which one do you think is yours?
No! I know where the tower is.
Hey, you can't just say he's gone. You owe us an ending.
I owe you nothing. I am a dungeon master. I create a boundless world, and I bind it by rules. Too heavy for a bridge? It breaks. Get hit, take damage. Spend an hour outside someone's front door fighting over who gets to kill him? He leaves through the back. You are still at the entrance to the Chamber of Grief. Your move, Mr. Tickles. You successfully pour more tea into Count Frogula's cup. That puts it at Hillary Rodham Kitten. Okay. You attempt to pass crumpets. You fail. Okay, guys, I'm getting a little frustrated. If you just take a look at your inventories, you'll see that...
Abed, are you almost done? I can't sleep without my stuffies.
Fine, hold on. Oh, a goblin notices you and murders you all. You're dead. They're all yours.
Oh, Jeffrey, are you okay?
No, he's not. Take it from an expert in delusion. If Jeff's hallucinating something this cool, something's wrong. He needs to get back. I guess you found a way to deal with it unconsciously through a psychotic break. Happens to the best of us.
He's been 32. We have to know he would be...
This isn't helping.
You guys know I'm 38, right? I'm kidding. But Jeff, you shouldn't almost die over a number. What's important are ranges of numbers. Fully animated? But it was all a dream because you were unconscious. Remember that Christmas when I...
Yes!
What the hell was that?
But was what?
That long, quiet lull. I don't like it.
It's called contentment, dude.
Exactly. We're never content. Someone's always got to have a problem.
I got a problem. I don't like Abed's problem with our lack of problems. I commented on his commentary. I just drew a circle around Abed, baby.
I don't think it's nice to pigeonhole people's gimmicks.
You hear me too, boys?
Nice. Jeff's heart's in the right place, but he's wrong. Greendale is a crazy place where crazy things happen. I have a plan.
There is no story.
Everything's a story, Jeff. Getting out of bed is a story. Certainly this is a story. I mean, start with the study room. We're content. I'm concerned. Skip the fruit matching stuff. Dean enters with the insurance appraiser story. Call, refusal. You're literally dragging me across a threshold demanding there be no story, which puts me into a whole new world that I'm gonna have to adapt to.
We have to do it by yourself, please, okay? Because if this appraisal is a story, that means we're in trouble, and we are not in trouble. Because if we are,
no more stories.
Ta-da.
All right, no story. Wait, if there's no story, what am I explaining? I'm in a story. Okay, think of it, think. No! It's always a story! Everything is a story! Wait, wait, wait. Story feeds on conflict. If I stop resisting, it'll stop being a story.
No, Abed.
Me with a beard.
Keep fighting the story. Keep fighting it until it falls apart.
All right. I mean, I'm wrong. I mean, I'm right. I mean, I'm wrong. I mean, I'm right. I mean, I'm wrong. I mean, I'm right. I mean, I'm wrong.
Unsubscribe.
Chang just unexpectedly...
Mary Treasure! Lock the doors, close the blinds.
We could save Greendale, Jeff. There may be treasure on campus.
Hidden Mary Treasure! This is the kind of adventure I usually have to force upon us, and here it is, falling into our laps. We're like the Goonies, except our story tracks logically and has a chance of holding up to objective critical scrutiny years later. Will you stop that? Can you please stop that?
You guys are ridiculous together. We're ridiculous. What do you call this?
Secret trap door.
Booyah. Spider webs of beanbag chairs.
Oh, don't cry. The importance of lumbar support hadn't been established.
Not that. It's just...
Annie, look, I don't know people, but I know TV. When characters feel like the show they're on is ending, their instinct is to spin off into something safer. In Jeff and Britta's case, something that would last 6 episodes and have a lot of bickering about tweezers and gluten, starring them and an equally waspy brunette couple with a title like Better With My Worst Half or Awfully Wedded or Tying the Knot But Not As Spelled Without a K or hashtag Couple People Problems.
Abed.
In every episode, you get to decide who wins the fight by going...
Abed, stop developing!
Sorry.
Got it. Thank you, Abed.
You're welcome. I have a girlfriend.
What?
You were about to start a kiss lane?
I was not.
Fine, let's go find treasure. Try track 127.
Right, because 127 in binary code would be a palindrome.
Because the song title is Open the Door by the Secret Doors. Jeff, in case you ever have to remember me, can I give you some options for voiceover quotes?
Shut up, Abed.
We'll definitely be back next year. If not, it'll be because an asteroid has destroyed all human civilization. And that's canon.
What?
Abed and Nadir, who actually wrote this announcement for the sake of, as he put it, catching everyone up,
I've been reliving this day over and over for 1,000 years.
I was waiting until we were all together. Abed's not comfortable with C-H-A-N-G-E.
Hey, screw you, I can spell. Screw you.
Is Shirley gone? Did she spin off?
Nobody spins off in real life, Abed.
But how much can you improve Greendale before it stops being Greendale? She didn't suffer for this place. Mm-hmm. She doesn't understand it. She's gonna end up messing with something that...
Abed!
Temporal! Mutation! English, Doc.
How's everything going?
I have concerns.
I'd like to hear them. But I myself am exceptionally boring, and I am quite proud to be that way because it allows me to help the less boring people turn quirks into results.
That's the most interesting take on not being interesting that I've ever heard.
Good shows change, I assume. Personally, I don't own a TV.
You're the first person to say that I didn't immediately delete from my brain.
Thank you.
She was nice to me. In fact, we kind of got along.
Sure she wasn't actually being sweetly condescending?
Yep, I learned to pick up on that one. Are you guys sure she's bad? Are you sure you're not doing what I usually do, overreacting to change?
Nobody's ever doing what you usually do, Abed. You're nuts. In a good way.
Can I hang around if I don't do the oath?
Oh, gee, you mean just be friends? Sure, great, Abed.
Okay. Because I don't think you're evil. I think you scare people because you live in the real world instead of up your butt.
Abed.
Yeah?
What are you doing?
What do you mean?
Someone told me you were sweeping, straightening clocks. Why are you cleaning that sign? I gave you a list.
Yeah, the list felt pretty similar visually. I can't picture a montage cutting from me verifying Diane's invoice to me emailing confirmation to Diane.
But a montage is what, Abed?
It's a movie apologizing for reality.
And we are where?
Reality?
And what do people do here?
Then email Diane.
Hey, Abed.
Hey, Todd.
Maybe you should order the special.
I'll have the special.
The specials are kept in the back. You should go in the back.
Put on an old-timey jacket.
That's okay, I don't really do this anymore. All right, come on. I said I don't do this, see? You guys know about tardigrades? They're these microscopic creatures that look like robot bears.
They can survive in space. Get into space, you dirty tardigrade. See?
But it wasn't enough. You had to drag Abed back in, and Abed deserves better.
It's not their fault, Frankie. I chose this. These are my friends. I hate emailing Diane. She can't commit to a font. It's pathological. And so am I. This is where I belong.
I know you think that, Abed, but you don't know any better.
Whoops.
I'm better than this.
Abed, I'm really sorry.
I told you cats don't like me. They consider me a competitor because of my natural stealth and ambivalence. We're just falling on hard times, and our apartment is the cheapest game in town.
Abed, it's a little embarrassing when you put it that way.
Britta's a rich genius with superpowers, and she's gonna live on our sofa for no reason.
Abed, you're more machine than man. You want to give me a hand setting up the equipment after lunch?
We're all gonna help Britta move into our place today.
Oh, Britta! It's okay.
Do I do this too? Okay.
This is gonna be good for all of us, right? It's like a fresh start. Look, that seems weird, right?
Roommate movie night! Are you strong or angry?
My parents.
Well, are we? Okay.
Well, they are! Worried.
What happened to the kid's green machine?
What? I don't know. I ditched it.
Where and how long ago? Okay, I assume that's not what's important here.
Why are you so awake?
I have a theory about this. Britta may be secretly twins.
Still going to Greendale? Thought you should know. City College is running a negative.
I'm working on getting us a copy. I have friends in the AV department at City College.
Ooh la la.
The Brotherhood of AV exists beyond your petty factionalism. We serve only video, the one true queen, and her faithful consort, audio. Oh,
could you guys be bigger nerds?
No, most of us have achieved our maximum potential.
There are no...
Abed, can you make one of those attack ads?
Jeff wants me to make an attack ad. So why is he a pedophile? Just demonstrating the formula.
Well, you can refine your technique as you go.
I want to know. Would it be better if
no.
we... No. Never know until you try.
Never know until I try.
What?
I said we're quite a team.
We could use some fresh eyes on this cut.
We could?
Has anyone told you you're difficult to work with?
Everyone in your line of work.
Abed, I don't want to talk right now.
Okay.
Who are you?
I'm the plumber.
Why?
Here's why.
Oh, God!
Is this pornography? You're the only actor.
So?
What kind of lens is this?
Who cares?
You might be a genius. Why did you do this? The Wi-Fi is still broken.
What happened to good morning?
It's a bad morning. No Wi-Fi.
Elroy, you're the IT lady.
Can I be his assistant?
Not for money.
Can I be his friend?
Elroy Abed is your friend. Now, the real...
What's going on?
There's a bird's nest in there with babies in it. The mother must have built it there because of the heat. Same reason my mom took my half-brother to Arizona.
That's probably why the Wi-Fi is down. We'll have to move it.
If you move him, the mother won't come back. The mother won't come back.
Kid, animals have been murdering each other for 3 billion years.
What are you, a demon? Did Clive Barker write you?
Anyone who finds that nest will come to the same decision. And you don't have to get mean.
Mean? You just did a baby bird murder monologue. Maybe they're close to leaving the nest. Until then, can't you just stall by doing what real IT people do?
What's that?
Exactly.
All right, IT lady, how goes it?
I found your problem.
And?
I'll need a little time to fix it.
Wow, need time to fix it. You sound just like you work in IT. I've got some interest.
The internet says if they're sparrows, they'll be flying in less than 12 days. If they're albatrosses, we're in trouble. Albatrosses have a 270-day fledging period. Thanks for guarding the nest with me.
Your lifestyle is alternative. Your influence is positive. You represent the changing of the tide. Gating, 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 gating. I'm begging you to be a gating for the school board.
I'm sorry, Abed. I lost myself in a role. It won't happen again.
Two of them died. There's one left. He's hanging on, but I'm worried he's turning into a symbol of my own innocence. And now, everyone, please put on your cat masks and finger wings. Wings, everyone.
You did the right thing, Abed. Thanks to you, that bird has his whole bird life ahead of him. To fly, meet ladybirds, even start a bird family. You made a difference. Abed.
Is this a cult? Are you going to eat me?
No, we're fine. I lived in New York.
Now, hold on. Are you trying to tell me that prisoners would use these things to come to our school?
That's the black guy in every sci-fi movie.
I'll allow it.
Wait.
Oh, yeah. I remember when she first moved in. That was back when I was so worried about pacing, I was constantly laying groundwork for pop-back gags. Hey, Annie. You're saying I was first in the apartment, so I could overrule Annie and let you have a party. But I don't get anything out of parties. They're like conventions for every subject too boring to have their own convention. And instead of Joss Whedon, the police show up.
The police also showed up when you made Leonard take off his clothes and filled the living room with lizards.
That was from my movie, Reverse Godzilla. I also thought I might make a good pop-back. I make movies, Britta. I make movies, Annie makes rules, you make parties. Her rules cancel out your parties, but I'm not involved. I just make movies.
Abed, it's 6 a.m.
Okay, thanks. Are you joking? This is the reason I signed on to this film. I think it's a performance issue. I think this needed some real actors.
Well, lesson learned.
Yeah.
Party, 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 party. Cut!
Abed. Britta has something to say.
Stupid. Parties are stupid.
I'm stupid. You're shooting a stupid movie.
That's a wrap.
What's gonna happen to me? You're going to be punished. In ways you won't understand for longer than you think is rational or possible. But then one day, you'll do something he likes and he'll stop. And eventually you'll either adapt or lose your mind. Okay.
It's WASD to move. It's been the same since the invention of the keyboard.
Okay, nerd. I take it we're passing on their offer.
No, they're just amateurs. Initiating override protocol. All in favor of this purchase?
Affirmative.
Very well. Abeds, commence with world domination. Eradicate.
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 Eradicate. Eradicate.
Might as well bring dinosaurs back.
What?
Let her finish.
Frankie.
I hear the hackers leaked our emails.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not usually the best at nonverbal cues, so I have to ask. Is it possible that everyone here but me read all of each other's leaked emails?
Absolutely not possible.
I read it all! Okay, how much of the leak did each of you read? I have a right to fit in!
Abed, if you wouldn't mind, please, checking the sound system.
No problem.
Unless you're too busy telling your girlfriend I don't understand Donnie Darko. Annie. Cool.
It looks like Jeff Winger auto-paid his car insurance. And Annie's book club has a meeting tomorrow. Where did you guys find the bad stuff?
I'll start. Now, I'm sure by now you've all...
You two dated? Have been seeing a dramatic rise in guerrilla marketing.
Why do they need marketing? They're amazing.
It's guerrilla with a U.
Got it. I haven't exactly been a whirlwind of entertainment since Troy left.
That's not true.
It's not just me. You guys have been boring, too.
Okay, I
got up to make nachos, and Elroy said that was nacho job, and we laughed. Then he made them for me. It was more than wordplay. It really wasn't my job in his eyes.
I bet they'll be together for a very long time.
Hey, you got it.
This is great. Thanks.
A few brief moments of human vulnerability. Not really your wheelhouse.
Oh, I'm sure you have detailed files on human vulnerability, Abed.
What? Oh.
Whoa, take a knee, man.
Natalie is freezing.
At least I can finally clear some space in my hard drive.
Oh, Leonard's been in there for a while, but I can stand guard if you want to use the women's room.
Did he sign a release form?
Sure. I make all my actors sign releases before we do anything. You never know who is going to. That's about all we got. Chang found out the McRib was back and we lost the rest of the day. Great actor, huge McRib problem.
Have you seen Vin Diesel in 1996's Happy Pants?
No.
No, I have.
Well, neither is Vin Diesel. But his...
But I can't just burn up my cop drama. It's my only chance at the mainstream success I need before I'm allowed to make weird stuff for money.
That's what they do with Chris Pratt. They put him in a regular scene and then they add some gagoos.
I can't believe you guys are the ones pitching me this, and I can't believe I'm saying no. Okay, but I get Final Cut, and it has to be a good movie.
Agreed. But you have to finish that cut by Monday, even if it's bad.
I agree to that, but it has to be good by my standards.
I think we're all on the same page.
I guess so.
Let's crap out this piece of crap.
That attitude concerns me.
Why am I wearing a blouse? It's sci-fi. It doesn't matter.
Please don't say that. I know you don't mean that. But do you understand that sci-fi films aren't usually improvised over a weekend with a cast and crew that doesn't care?
Every day, I work out.
Really?
Get this session done, get out there, and get your shirt off. Got it?
Yes. Yes. Okay.
My eye fell off. But I covered.
Perfect, moving on.
Congratulations!
The swarming hornets?
No, nobody cares about labeling files. Teach me to edit.
What the hell was that? It's not even a movie, Jeff. It's a piece of crap.
That doesn't mean it can't be good.
It's basically exactly what it means.
You stay away, Abed. I'm not kidding. I will kill you in these frisbees and nobody will ever find you.
Okay, so now let's get familiar with the user interface.
No, just teach me to edit!
Do you
know what that means?
It means I'm a genius, but we already knew that. I didn't write that. We didn't plan that. God made that happen. God made this movie. And it's dumb. And we're dumb for being in it.
Will you do me a favor?
I never tell anybody about our private conversations. I wouldn't really know how.
Then you're gonna come crying back to me.
Why you? In class together, have a great time, and rub it in Jeff's face. I'll pay you back.
I'll get it from your parents.
Tell them I spit on their wealth, and thank you.
What?
My name is Slick Pockets Tucker.
No, it's not.
That's correct. I was just wondering what the next lesson will be.
Abed, why don't you marry the sting?
Okay, just so you know, if I do and we have half-sting children, when they ask me how to grip, I'm gonna tell them to watch their mother, not listen to you!
Yes!
Guess who's got fully charged phones?
Well charged.
Notable that the one we remember is the one with the theme of memory.
Way to make this about justifying your unmarketable sensibility.
Well, apparently armed...
This is a lot of narrative pipe. Maybe we did need a 3 weeks earlier flashback.
Abed, is this a show? I thought you said you knew it wasn't a TV show.
Fine.
Well, can I ask that it not be a show about you saying it's a show? Because dumb.
You're dumb.
Go in the back. Go in the back and sit by yourself.
Jeff, what's wrong with you?
I'm sick of it.
Yes.
I'm not sorry.
It's not good to be back. This was my show. You didn't give a damn about that.
Abed, we're all on your side, so if you're also on your side, it's petty.
What would Arnold Schwarzenegger sound like if he was bit by Dracula?
No. Sorry I've been unavailable. I've been trying to cut to 3 weeks earlier. It really feels like we needed that.
Then that solves the matter of the giant hand. If there's no other business...
In a normal road trip story, the first act would end with us deciding to go on the trip, the second act would be the trip ending with a disaster, and the third act would be us getting back. The problem is, we've already decided to take this trip weeks from now, which means the story starts with us already on the road, which means the end of Act 1 won't be us going on the trip, it'll have to be the disaster, which means something even worse has to happen in Act 2, unless we make the decision right now that Act 1 is a flashback, so that the beginning of the story is now instead of then. Jeff?
Abed, shut up. Go flashback and cut to stuff.
Extra thick straps! Extra thick straps! Extra thick straps! Extra thick straps!
There, that should do it.
What should do it?
We made sure the straps were extra thick, remember?
No, I don't remember because it didn't happen!
You didn't?
Now, Abed's the only human among you, and I think we all know how ironic that is. No offense, Abed.
None possible.
You bonded with him. Talk to him. You're alone in the end zone. This ball is yours or nobody's.
I appreciate your appeal to my well-known passion for athletics and sarcasm. My naive obsession with contrived flashback technique has kept me from being invested in any of this actual story. I mean, what was it even? A bunch of people in an RV? And I had the Christopher Nolan it?
And talking to the dean like a human.
That's my arc.
That's your arc.
Okay, here we go. I'd like to propose a heavy use of flashback in this episode. No, Abed, don't do it. Thanks, Abed!
Stop that! Get your head out of your ass!
I don't know how. I'm oversaturated with the gimmick. I don't know what's real. I don't...
You're lying. You have to be lying. You enjoy this.
Stop it. What has gotten into you? Why are you shocked that he's alienated?
You get him to do something normal without abusing him.
But the time we spend in control of our world is the time we spend letting go of others. Ideas, stories, pride, girls in soft sweaters, video games, buttered noodles. Grip one for too long and you lose so much that you've never held. I need ammunition.
Are you a narc?
Why would I answer that honestly?
Good point.
Easy target.
Who's heckling me? Oh, of course, it's the Indian guy.
I'm Arabic.
Gow! Okay, let's go with that.
And the Pope looks at the giraffe and says, I'm in the room. Sorry, I can't remember the whole joke.
That's okay. It sounds very funny based on the last line. Are you quite done?
Yeah. Garrett wanted the proposal recorded. He thought his family might want to see proof.
So now what are you shooting?
You had a strange look on your face.
Oh, you're noticing faces now?
Mm-hmm.
Aren't you still smelling hair to tell Frankie from Manny?
Yeah.
Abed, why bring a metronome?
I thought the sound might accentuate the anxious idleness of our last meeting's final seconds.
Good job, bad idea.
You guys think bar scenes always have to start on a billiard shot? Or do you think every time someone takes a shot in billiards, they start a new bar scene without knowing it?
What?
You can just say shut up, Abed.
Six seasons, right, Abed?
Don't put a nickel in him.
Is this combination gonna work?
Not my place to say, Abed.
Things have a certain structure to them, you know? If we stray from it, we're weird. If we stick to it, we're boring.
Yeah, but isn't that more about the shape of your brain, Abed? I mean, no offense or anything, but isn't the shape of your brain kind of fucked up?
It's TV. It's comfort. It's a friend you've known so well and for so long. You just let it be with you. And it needs to be okay for it to have a bad day or phone in a day. And it needs to be okay for it to get on a boat with LeVar Burton and never come back. I'm fine.
But six seasons in a movie.
Jeff, I know it comforts you to look at things through that meta lens, but this is reality. Are you guys doing an unauthorized finale in here? Not cool.
Abed, I know it gives you comfort to see everything through that meta lens.